guys. Hold on, just turning this down. Make sure Wi-Fi's on, Wi-Fi's on.
Hi, guys.
Happy, where are we at?
Thursday?
So, even though we're questioning the day.
Yeah, we were like, Thursday's looking a little busted. We might have to go back to Friday.
I know. It seemed like it looked good on paper, but in theory, it's not too great.
Yeah.
Cutting into my beautification night.
Girl, you look so busted right now.
Yes, but
I'm gonna start the live by telling you that.
As y'all know what this cap is, it's my deep conditioning cap. And I'm doing my skincare tonight, so not bothered.
Literally, we did not even know if we were gonna go live tonight, but somebody on Facebook, one of your Facebook friends, two of your Facebook friends were like so excited about live.
Mom.
And I'm like,
is she here yet?
We cannot not do live now. Like, bust it. Yeah. So
I know.
Hold on. Oh my gosh.
I can't even see. Wait.
My eyes are like rolling right now.
And I was watching some drama on the drama channels. Drama channels made for drama channels. I love it. Okay.
Oh my goodness.
Let me see.
Hi guys. I feel like it's been so long. How long has it been? Like a week?
Ish.
We didn't talk to them the week of Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
So how was everybody's Thanksgiving? What'd you eat? Who were you with? How was
let's
it?
See. All right, let's see here. The same characters. Same victims.
Lorraine's gonna air me out tonight because I said I wasn't doing any Black Friday shopping.
Girl, guys.
I was leading
them. She was juggling bags. Like, I don't know who. Like, she was trying to go into the door sideways so she could get all the bags. And I'm like, oh my gosh. Like, you talked everybody into not doing it.
Listen.
You're like, oh, there's nothing out there. The sales are horrible.
Listen. It's Spencer's fault. It is Spencer's fault because he asked me to go to the mall with him on Black Friday to find a pea coat. And some of the stores he likes to shop in, I like to shop in, and I bought a few sweaters, and I was like, you know, what's a few sweaters? You know,
between friends.
But it was 30%. That was the exact percentage. I was like, that's not a sale, but I bought some H&M sweaters
you
for 30% off.
I think you can't just blanket statement say that, say, 15% or 25% or 30% is awful, because it depends on the store.
Yeah.
Like, 30% got me, you know, those bracelets that I wear. I don't have them on tonight because I'm not beautifying tonight, but you know all those bracelets I wear, those little kind of little ribbon bracelets from Paris? Well, they're never on sale, so 30%, hey, I'll load up the cart.
Kia Lammy, where are you at? She said they got 2 feet of snow.
Really?
Yeah, so Monday there was no school, and then Tuesday was a 3-hour delay. Ma, that is a thing. Yeah. I had an ask today, because I did some subbing today, and I was like, I don't know, because Connecticut has so many snow days. Like, it was something with, like, the teachers and, like, their pay or something like that. Like, they didn't want to lose days. So now they give them, like, more time or something. But, like, the schools now in our district do 3-hour delays. And I'm like, I've never heard of a three. I've heard of, like, two.
How does that compute? Like, what does 3 hours do for?
I know. I guess just more time to clean it up. Maybe 2 hours wasn't enough. 1 hour wasn't enough. So now they do 3 hours and, like, you go to school. It counts as a school day.
Okay.
They get you in there. And so I was like, 3 hours? I've never seen that before.
The chocolate pina said she worked on Thanksgiving and Black Friday. Where do you work? That's awful.
Deidre Bivens, Tara, you're still eating leftovers. I stopped on Tuesday. You stopped on, like, Saturday?
I think I stopped on Saturday.
Yeah, I went until Tuesday.
Yeah.
And we had to throw food away. I was sad. I hate throwing Thanksgiving.
Yeah, you know, but it wasn't as much as we thought.
No, it really wasn't.
Because I never knew that, like, Adam and Spencer like the macaroni and cheese kind of like souffle thing when you kind of, you know, we've done the whole
like
thing.
The casserole?
The egg mixture. I thought they just like macaroni on the stove, I boil it and then sprinkle some cheese on it and throw it in the microwave, and that's macaroni and cheese for years. But for Thanksgiving, like, you know, how we all do the macaroni and cheese, and I didn't think that they ate it like that, but I'm telling you, that great
they
thing
did. Did.
Went.
The macaroni and cheese went first this year. Yeah.
And I really didn't compute it right, because I bought 3 boxes of pasta and I probably only needed about 2. And so there was just a lot of boiled pasta sitting in the water, all soft, and it was just
we made like too much of stuff. So we're like, okay, next year we have to remember, like, we don't need 3 boxes of pasta for macaroni and cheese.
Right.
We only need like 2.
And that is many
or 1.5.
Beans, right.
Yeah, we had way too many string beans this year.
And this whole idea of me getting
the gravy we messed up on. Gravy was awful.
The gravy was not messed up. There was no gravy because I had to make a turkey. I got a Kentucky. I don't know, it was like a little thing.
I don't know. It was like already. already made. It was like a cook. It was like a.
Did it taste like turkey?
Yeah, it did. I thought it was good.
Okay.
I mean, I don't need a great big like bird in the middle of the table all the time. No. So this year, it was like the way our ham looked. The turkey looked just like that. We bought one that looked just like that.
Right.
And we cooked it in the oven what do you do? You do like onions, carrots, celery. Yeah. Like, you season
it. I did all of that stuff.
Like, and it was good. Yeah. But it just wasn't a gigantic.
Is this something about bird? The gigantic bird.
It was like cooked. And you had to kind of like reheat it and season it, and it was good.
Then you ran off and got turkey gravy. Everybody knows turkey
gravy. Yeah, because
gravy,
when you actually cook the turkey, like the juices from it, you make the gravy from it. Since we didn't actually have a bird like that, there was no juice.
What did Spencer say? Just empty calories.
Yeah, and I asked him. I was like, "How's the gravy?" I went and just bought like a can, like a thing of gravy, and he was like, "It tastes like nothing." So, is your dad still there? No, he went back.
Yeah, he went back because of the storm.
There was a snowstorm coming. Mm-hmm. He went back, but...
So he was going to stay till Tuesday, and then he went back that Saturday. So that was really early. But he's coming back for Christmas, so... No worries there. I'm thinking... Somebody 65% off at Honey's Handmade. I didn't make my way over there, though I wanted to. What did I want? But I don't know, maybe they'll be like everyone else. I got an email today from Sotanicals. Guys, how many more Sotanicals emails could we get?
Y'all.
And they ain't had nothing.
Love Sotanicals so much.
Love them
but
so much.
The
nobody
award
loved them more than me.
For the most emails, promotion goes to Sotanicals. My phone, bing, bing, bing.
And every
bing,
time you go
bing,
over there,
like five or six times a day.
You get excited and they're like,
so
back
funny.
In stock. And when you click on it, out of stock, so everything was out of stock.
That's why,
so
girl.
Boring,
they make it sure. Mm-hmm. If you want another website, come over to Sotanicals. Bing, bing.
No, we're not bashing them because we all been through the same thing. We all know this. But what I wanted was that fenugreek, and I'm still going to get it. Today I got an email, one of the million emails we got throughout this Black Friday, Small Business Sunday or Saturday, Cyber Monday. Now I see Cyber Week. I'm insane. They want our money. Everybody wants our money.
But they make you feel like you have to rush and get it Black Friday, Cyber Monday. And I'm like, I'm basically walking. I'm like, because these sales are going to go on the whole week, the whole month.
So
Tanical
said, don't worry for those that missed out. There'll be sales for plenty. There'll be sales for all.
Yeah, Lisa Powell said, and so Tanical said nothing. I know, because you, every time you got the email, you went straight to the website because you wanted the fenugreek.
I want the fenugreek.
And like, everything was sold out. I'm like, when it gets sold out, because like they're making sure people know.
I wanted to
come
get the,
over here.
The rice butter shampoo. I wanted to get the rice tonic. Sold out. Sold out. Sold out. What was new this year? Was that the only thing, the fenugreek, or was there anything else new? Because everything was sold out.
I'm Jurassic Coleman. My IG was flooded with Allocay. Yep, we were part of the Allocay promotion. We got on board. So, I mean, it's smart for companies to get, you know, influencers get who they can to, like, promote their companies for Black Friday. Because there's a ton of companies.
Let me see. Luxlox has deals through the 8th. Okay.
Yeah. That's what's in my hair right now. This is actually, like, day 3, I think, of, like, a Luxlox braid out. And I've been just using the pineapple leave-in. I love just using, like, a light leave-in to, like, braid my hair up. And so, that's what's been happening.
Two things. All right, so who said they love my hoodie? Kay Pagan. It's from J. Crew. It's cute. Though I have to say the quality, as my grandmother said, J. Crew of old probably would have had this kind of like olive green, you know, the white to me kind of like cheapened it a little bit, but it's cute. You know, it's cool. It's so cute that I got you one because you love it so much.
Yes, we have matching.
So.
I should have put it on.
It is J. Crew. Go on over there now. Like, everything's 40% off.
But then, like, 40% off for J. Crew is, like, I guess good, but they're expensive. So I hate when I see, like, 90% off and it's, like, you know, a $2,000 sweater. Like,
except for the guys. Like, I saw the shirts. Like, I got Spencer a ton of shirts for Christmas because I've never seen shirts that low. 50% off. I got them the day they were 50% off, and that was pretty good. It wasn't even 50%, it was like 66% off. And it definitely left that sale because when I returned, they're not on sale anymore. So that was a good deal. Like some of the 3 came in the mail today, and more is coming in the mail.
What was Mael's shipping? I think Sarah Fentine said that all their products were $5, which that's a good sale for. Mm-hmm. For Mael. What was the shipping though? I feel like for Black Friday, free shipping should have just been a given.
Okay, you was on the cover of Honey's Handmade on Black Friday.
Hey. Mm-hmm. Free shipping should have just been a given. Where did I shop? So H&M, mm-hmm. And then I ordered from Forever 21 because the skirt I've been like watching for like months. was on sale for like $5. It went from $27 to $5, so I bought two, like the two different colors that they had, because I kind of like wearing skirts to work, and so I did that, even though I got an email saying that, of course, like basically all the companies are saying they got like so many orders that your order's coming eventually, like give them time. Mm-hmm. They're like, but in the meantime, here's a 20% off coupon for your next like to spend some more money.
Yeah, that's what Leah Shabazz, same thing, because we were going to do a video for our like our Black Friday haul, but I said it's not here yet. Like, it's going to be trickling in.
Yeah.
So I did, I'm waiting, like, more J. Crew stuff for Spencer, more J. Crew stuff for myself. I did Target. I got, like, all these sheets. I like that. Was it Hearth and Home?
I bought some stuff from Target.
Was it Hearth and Home?
Hearth and Home?
Hearth and whatever. They're sheets. I like those. I got those. So I did a lot of Target sheet kind of things. So the deals were really good. Sheets are expensive.
I got a teddy coat. So, but it was from the store name, Rainbow in the mall. But they had a sale. Guys, you all know Rainbow. You guys know Rainbows where you are. But they had a really nice teddy coat, and I really wanted a teddy coat. But all the teddy coats I'd been seeing were like $100, and I was like, I'm not paying that for a coat. So, but theirs was like $34, and it was so cute. I wanted like a kind of like a brown teddy coat. It kind of looks like Teddy Lulu, if you're familiar with Teddy Lulu on the channel.
And then you organized my Paris bracelets.
Yes.
Because that's why I said I wanted for Christmas. And so you told me just to order all of them, like pick out all the ones I want. And then you went around like the tax collector collecting money from everybody. Like, this is what she wants for Christmas. So cough up the moolah. And so that was pretty cool. Because yeah. That's what I want. So they're not here yet, but they're
like,
they're on
all right,
way.
Everybody, here's the bill. Yeah. We're splitting it all these ways. And there we go. So we did not buy hair products. We did. That's why I said, Mom, like, we're kind of like a hair channel. I was like, I don't know if they're going to want to see our haul if it's not hair products, because we definitely did. I mean, like, to be honest, like, as influencers, like, we get sent products. So I'm not going out to really buy anything. There's nothing I really needed. I didn't need any new deep conditioners, no gels, no.
Well, it's a one time send. It's not always, because
that's
now
true,
you
but
want,
like, but
now
it's
you
like.
On Meesh, and we were just like,
that is very true.
Now you like all that decluttering that we did.
Right. I gave away, because when Meesh originally sent us products, they sent us two of everything, because there's two of us. And we did our mystery boxes. I believe I gave away our second set of like their entire line ish. Let me backtrack. I gave away the leave-in and the butter, but now I regret giving away the butter, because I'm like, I actually really, really like the butter. I'm out of the butter, so now I have to buy the butter. But I didn't want to buy any products. Even Body Works had like a $6 sale, right?
Flower Trusted, I spent nearly $200 on botanicals this year.
Ooh,
what time did you?
She must have gotten in like the second thing open,
right? Wow, okay. All right, so I'm going to take this off my head. Okay, guys, so I did a DIY. I'm going to be seeing it for the first time. I'm deep conditioning with, I'm back hooked on Janssen's, Camille Rose Janssen's, but the directions kind of changed. I used to put it in. They said put it in and rinse out. It smells the same. It feels the same, all that. But now the directions say keep it in for 35 minutes, which is a weird kind of a time. But anyway, I did. But on top of that, I did my DIY toner. My hair was getting more and more brassy. And as I always say, highlights are supposed to be ashy, not golden and brassy. So I researched it and I found that if you mix blue food coloring, and this is weird, red and blue to make purple if you don't have purple. And I said, that's really weird, because that red to me would make it warm. But when it...
You put red in there?
Yeah, but when I hit that, then the key I think was that baking soda. So when I put the baking soda in there, and then I put in Meesh shampoo, they said just grab your normal shampoo. So I grabbed my shampoo, and that baking soda kind of made it like an exfoliator. And when I put all those colors together, it turned almost like a bluish greenish.
I knew you were upstairs, too quiet.
So let's see, guys, if my hair is going from orange to ashy. Let's see. The big reveal. All right. I still see some.
I was gonna say it's warm on the top of your head. Still.
Okay, all right, is it?
All right. Yeah, it is.
Still warm?
It's maybe still, has to do. It's still pretty warm.
Okay, but it's not that warm, is it? It looks a little ashier, doesn't it? No.
Maybe wait, hold on. I'll let flip it and flop it. Like here. It's, okay, maybe it's right here. It looks a little, but right here.
Maybe once it dries. Don't forget this is wet.
This is copper.
Girl,
and right here.
Guys, just listen
to her. Girl, what'd you do? Oh, the back of your head doesn't look as copper.
Well, maybe because it wasn't as many highlights back
there. What do you normally do?
No, I think to me, looking at myself, I think it looks ashy. It doesn't look as gold as it normally is. It doesn't look as brassy. I think it looks, it's headed, girl, she's a hater. See, not bothered. All right, I'm probably have to just do it again. I think it looks good.
So those products that Meech had were limited edition. I saw them and I was going to pick them up. But again, I was like, I'm not buying hair products. I'm not doing it.
All right, what do y'all think? Does it look ashy or does it look?
Because I just like buying clothes for work. Like I had a whole work wardrobe that I completely gave away over the summer when we did our Goodwill giveaway. And so now I have to restock up on all my teaching clothes. And so I have plenty of hair products. I'm like, I don't need to buy hair products.
Yeah, it definitely looks moisturized, right?
What deep conditioner do you use?
I use Janssen's. Like I was saying, Janssen's, is this called Janssen's, right? Mm-hmm. Moisture Max. Okay, Camille Rose.
Moisture Max conditioner.
I used to love it. They had it in the bottle, okay, and then they switched over to a jar, which I always said. To me, it competed with Aloe, that Aloe deep conditioner, that Aloe Renew. Is it called Aloe Renew? Okay, I swore that the Janssen's.
Algae.
Guys.
We got there.
I swore that the Algae Renew was good. I love that one. But when I tried Janssen's, I said, this needs to be a deep conditioner. This, to me, was more moisturizing than the Algae Renew. So, and they put it in a jar. And to me, the instructions speak towards like a deep conditioner. So 35 minutes today, whereas the ones in the bottle used to say, even though it smells the same, it feels the same, all of that, I think it's the same. But the one in the bottle used to just say, put it in and rinse it out. And today this one said, put it in and leave it in for 35 minutes, which are the new instructions on the jar now. Even though to me, everything, I compare the ingredients, all of that, it's identical. But they probably finally kind of made it like a deep conditioner of sorts. So that's what I put in. My hair is always super soft and moisturized.
So some people said they already had carts full of stuff. So like Sultanicals already had stuff in the cart. So basically when the shop opened,
that was smart.
They just checked out. That's smart.
That's very smart.
That is very, okay. Very smart.
I need a mirror. I don't have my normal mirror.
I mean, if you guys want to see the Black Friday haul, I know. Well, I basically all my stuff is here, except two skirts. Because I did just a lot of like in-store shopping that day with Spencer. So. We are on month 3 of our Curlsmith hair vitamins. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, me and you both have said we started noticing a little bit of shedding today. You came in, you were like, is this a lot of hair? But you hadn't done your hair in a week.
Yeah.
I feel like mine is shedding a little bit.
Thanksgiving. And
someone said fenugreek is in stock now, Lorianne.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, everybody remain calm.
Everybody remain calm.
Okay.
Okay, let's see. But see, I'm not paying like a great big price for shipping for just one product. I have to be able to take my time and peruse the site. Like, I know I'm going
to
have to.
What else would you get? Do they have like any, do they have any good like creams or?
Let me see.
What else?
Live shopping with Lorianne. Let me see. Yeah, because I keep checking back. They said keep checking.
So where else did you guys shop at? Did anybody shop with Nature's Little Secret? Or I know some people were buying the Irish Moss Styling Cream. Who else? There was one more brand that I wanted to ask about. It was them.
See, like you probably just hit a cursory glance because as soon as you go on there, it says sold out. See, guys,
you gotta put it all the way forward and tilt it. Girl, bust it. Sold out.
That's why I keep getting caught for that. I keep saying, oh my God, I get an email, everything's back in stock. I go over there and it's sold out. I know anybody doing all that much shopping. So, what in the world?
Email me when it's available. Why do you sign up for that?
Because I never check my emails. I was telling my mother today, I have over 76,000 emails. I never check my emails.
Who has more emails than Lorianne? She has 76,000.
And if you guys ever email me and you get a response back, like, wow, because I just happened to be there that night for whatever reason. I don't know. Every now and then I peruse by my emails to see what's going on. And I'll just see a Mad Curls fan member or somebody asking for advice. Or they'll kind of like stand out in the email and they'll say, hi, Mad Curls. I'm like, oh, it's a Mad Curls fan. Let me just see what this email says. And then I'll answer an email. But, I never,
18,000, 58,000, over 100,000. So I have a friend with 513 unread texts. Oh no.
Wow.
I could never.
Yeah, my mother said she catches not that many every people. Single day. She said she had 15. Like she said she checks them like a couple times a day. Like a businesswoman, I guess. Even though she's not a businesswoman. I'm like, who does that? Well, I guess she does, but no. I have a lot.
What's this? Yeah. Twist Assist Supernatural Fragilistic Stress Free Afro Aloe. Okay, it's too much.
Oh, that's a lot.
All of that. The Twisting Cream. Who's tried that? I never heard of that before.
Twisting Cream? Is that
it
new?
It says Twisting Cream. Twist Assist, Supernatural, Fragilistic,
Stress-Free,
Supercalifragilistic,
XBL. Ah, we got okay, there.
I got it.
Okay.
Cool.
Okay. It was 36,000. I check most of them. I just don't delete them. Yeah, see, I don't want to. I could go, like, come away from the app. No, I'm not in the app. Am I in the app? I don't know. I don't know. Is that an app? Is that considered an app? All right, I could go over to like the www.whatever and just like do a bulk delete. But I'm just afraid like there's just something. Like now I definitely won't because all that shopping I did, I definitely have to see what's going on. Now today, Amazon was supposed to be sending me my Crest whitening strips and doggy's blankets. He needed blankets. And then I got a doggy rug for the door because of all this sand and snow and all that. And what else do I? Oh, then like a chamois to dry them off.
A Shamu. Isn't Shamu a whale?
I don't know.
Speaking of doggy, can you
lean sideways? Is he okay?
Hi, baby.
Yeah, he's just looking.
Okay.
Yeah. But then they said it was delivered, but it wasn't delivered. So I'll give it like another day, you know, to get themselves together.
Yeah, where did I just see? Tracy Watson. She said, I love your hair. It looks like it's really growing. Yeah. So basically I've just been doing braid outs. And I'll do a wash and go, like, here and there. Like, I don't know. The braid out gives my hair, like, an elongated look, which is what I like. I have to try a braid out with, like, a side part now. See if I can kind of flip my hair to the side. But when it's in wash and go mode, the bangs are still kind of, like, floating up here. They're taking forever to grow. Yes, yes. And then I did a twist out, which was fun. Like, a chunky twist out. I like that. It was a different look. It was definitely shorter, but it was, bless you, but it was fuller. So I don't know, the wash and go, the braid out, and the twist out all give my hair like a different look. But I did the chunky twist out with the meat butter, and I really liked it.
I hate the red notification, so I constantly delete.
Girl, this year hair is growing too, girl.
Yeah, I know. I think I'm going to 2020. I'm going to let it grow.
Oh,
I think, to
yeah.
See what's going on here.
Me yeah. too. Yeah. No, I'm done. I'm done out here in these cutting streets. Yeah. Except I will go to Luvina Leslie, that curly hair salon in New Haven, just to trim my ends. I'll let her just trim my ends. Every couple of months, but that's about it.
Right.
Nothing drastic. No one's gonna be showing off on my head, showing what they can do, their skills, cutting bangs, cutting whatever. Absolutely not. Like, no, we're done. We're done out here in these style hair cutting streets.
Yeah.
No more. So I'm just gonna let my hair grow.
Yeah, today I felt like I lost a whole lot, but then you said me and all that castor oil, you said you have to kind of like wash it out.
Which I don't know why you don't remember that.
Yeah,
the last time you did the challenge, the first, like, it happened to you twice, and by the second time you had a big chop, like, her hair dread it really bad. Because I think it was already shedding, and then you left it in your hair for a long time. And castor oil's thick, so I was like, you need to move it in and out of your hair at least every 2 to 3 days. Like, it needs to come out. But you left it in for a week. And so I was like, I'm surprised you were able to get, like, a
comb. Well, like, I left it, and I was adding to it. Left it in and was adding to it daily.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, so that was...
Your head didn't itch?
Not at all.
Oh, my God, my head would have been on fire, my scalp. Mm-mm. Speaking of scalp. I'm still loving the Curl Smith. Is that light on in the hall?
You were
the Curl Smith scalp care. Did anybody get that Black Friday?
Oh, what?
Curl Smith, the scalp care line.
Oh, I think Erica Fleming. I don't think she's on here yet. I think she told me.
Are we still here? Are we here? I'm sorry. Ooh, I could have sworn I turned. Why did that do that? Hold on, guys. Sorry.
I just cast oil in my hair every week.
Wow, I don't know how that got through. My phone is on silence. I don't know how that got through.
Yeah, I'm kind of like doing the challenge, Aaliyah, so that's probably what the issue is here because I'm doing it every single day in my hair, and so that's what I was doing, and I wasn't washing it out because I wasn't really going any place, and so I was just kind of like thinking it was adding more to it, but I forget that sometimes if you kind of like let it sit there like that because I felt like I lost an awful lot today, so I don't know. Yeah, who said that? What the King said, I was so sure Lorian was going to cut her hair. Yeah, I know. And I just might, if it, like, this is starting to be problematic
now.
What
do you mean? I thought you already cut it.
I did.
Cut it more?
Probably more, yeah, because it is kind of, like, growing. You know how
I Amy said, I want that scalp line. No, honestly, I'm telling y'all right now, it's making a top something this year. That Curl Smith line, I really love. So funny. Speaking of the top video we were going to do. Last year, we did top 5 brands that we agreed on. Like, literally, the video was, there was 5. And then we did products, disappointing videos, and then we did, like, the award ceremony. So we were already kind of starting to plan the other day. For our top 5. I'm like, okay, let's, like, how are we going to roll these out this December? Because those are basically our videos this month. All our award ceremonies, top 5 brands, top products, all that kind of stuff of 2019. So it's like, okay, brands. I'm like, you know, me and you both have to agree to, you know, five, period, in some type of order. And so as we, okay, you know, number one, we both said two different brands. We're like, what?
What?
That brand? What? Like, I'm like, okay, what about this brand? And you were like, huh? I'm like, no, yeah. But I don't want that brand. I'm like, okay. Like, this year, I don't know how we agreed last year. I don't know how we did it.
I don't know how we agreed.
Every time we both kind of, like, made a list of brands, and I think, like, one or two crossed over.
This year, our journeys were different. I think that you were experiencing hair loss. I was not really bothered. Like, I think we had kind of, like, more days off, and we enjoyed things more. We did a lot of mix-it-ups. I think that was new to this year. Mm-hmm. Maybe it started maybe last year, I think. Maybe, I don't know. It could have started this year. But I felt like we did more mix-it-ups, and so I think we experimented more. We didn't stick, you know, like when we first came on YouTube, we were just kind of like doing like these brand tutorials, like rolling out like the entire brands. And I think we did more mix it ups. So we experimented more. So
yeah, for those of you who like know us and like really watch our videos, like what do you think will be in our top five? Because we definitely said we got to split it up. So I guess it's going to be my top five, your top five, either in the same video or separate videos. I don't know. We're not sure yet. But we were like, yeah, no, this year, I don't think we can just have five, period, because basically like your brands I didn't really agree with. For me,
no, you didn't.
I'm like, no, I didn't really use those brands. And you're like, really? And then for me, like, you were really? Like, what? Like, yeah. I didn't use that.
I know. Like, I'm like, are you serious? Yeah.
So what do you guys think? What are some of L'Oreal's brands? What are some of my brands? Like, what do you think?
Because we really didn't do a lot of tutorials, so it was more about basing it on my days off, what I reached for the most on my days off.
Yes, because I started all the way back in January. I'm like, we did tutorials this year, and we tried new brands and different things. I'm like, but not in like our previous year. I think when we first came on the channel, like that first year, maybe year and a half, it was tutorial, like straight tutorials. Why her's falling out now? It was just that was what our channel was, all tutorials. Now we do the tutorial here and there, we do vlogs, we do declutters, we do obviously our live streams, and like we do different things. So it's not just every single video you get is a tutorial. I'm like, so that makes it hard this year because we really didn't dive into products
I'm seeing things like they're throwing out, like they're thinking like definitely Sotanicals, Allocate, and Miche. I'll be surprised. Curl Mix, Nature's Little Secret, Camille Rose. Camille Rose, when the last time we had them on the channel till tonight? Okay, so no.
L'Oreal's Botanicals, Tay Curl Smith, so.
Yeah, not necessarily. Yeah. You know, there's certain things in the lines that we use that were staples that we, like, that crossed over from the year before that we definitely use on our days off. Definitely Sotanicals, deep conditioners, period. You know?
Versus pattern. Yeah, I mean, there were some at the end that came sliding through that I'm like, I really enjoy this brand. Like, I really enjoy patterns. Cleansers, which I don't know if I said that in the video. I think I said I wouldn't get the conditioners, which now that it's so hard doing reviews because like it was kind of like a first impression ish like with the conditioners, and maybe it was like my first second time using them, and
what?
The pattern conditioners.
Okay,
but now I really like them in the shower. I think they're really great for winter. It's a great thick in shower conditioner. I really enjoy the pattern shampoo and their conditioners. Really great.
So did I, Curls in the Making. That's what I wanted. Is that the only thing that they made new for Black Friday, the Fenugreek deep conditioner?
You see doggy. You're on doggy watch if you're sitting there. You gotta lean over every now and then. But you don't got distance glasses. Did you do bustedness? You're standing up. You must see something.
I can't see, so let's see.
Yep, he did.
Okay,
I got it. I knew that was
going to
happen.
Yes. We do not know how to train a dog. He definitely needs to be potty trained. Like, starting from chapter one, book one, it's like he's going backwards. Now, we don't know what this is about. Did we, like, overhype it up? Did we really think we did? You guys were so nice for those that are pet owners. And, when the first week we came out, we're like, oh, he's so potty trained. Like, literally, like, 1 week, never had a dog. And, like, he's potty trained. No, I mean, he's just doubling down on these accidents. Like, he is not bothered. And I guess maybe we have to do some professional help because he is just not bothered. We take him out, he goes to the bathroom outside, but yet he has no problem coming right back in a half hour later going inside. So I just don't understand it. I don't know how to do it. I don't know how to turn it around. I just really don't. Maybe we have to get professional help now. Like the dog was for something, seriously. I just don't know what to do, but no, it wasn't as easy as we thought. You know,
I mean, now we're trying. They said, like, don't discipline. They said, what do they say? Positive reinforcement. So, like, now when I take him out and he, like, pees and poos, I'm like, yay, good job. And I give him a treat. And, like, he comes running over for it. Mm-hmm. And yet, he still goes to the bathroom in the house. Like, I don't understand. Doggy, does that understand?
Yeah.
What's in my hair? I'm just deep conditioning my hair. I came on with my cap in a hot head. So that's all that's in my hair now. It just has to be rinsed out when I get off or something. Yep, that it kept selling out. Did anybody get the fenugreek? It seems to me that's an ingredient in a lot of things lately. I've seen that. Is that like the new it ingredient? He is. Where did you put Doug? He's in the kitchen with you while you're cleaning up.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, he's just in the kitchen. Tay's cleaning up. Again. So like I was saying, yeah, we have to get a handle on this. Oh, are hotheads on sale? Were they on sale? How much were they off this Black Friday? I ordered two of the fenugreek deep conditioners. Okay, it has been provided fenugreek mask. Okay, were you able to get those? Two of them? I definitely want to try it. I don't know, are hotheads on sale? Where are they on sale? They're $20. Wow. I know, Rochelle, I think that's what Jay was saying. Look at videos on YouTube, and maybe that's a start. But still, like watching videos, watching instructions, they make it seem so simple. And then, you know, in practice, it's just like he's like so not bothered. Even today, I don't know how you did it, Tay, when you would throw a ball at him and he'd grab the ball and bring it back to you. I kept trying to entertain him today, like throwing the ball. I'm like, Dougie, bring it back, bring it back. He would like walk on by or grab it, run out the room with it. I'm like, Dougie, bring it back. I had snacks, I had treats. I was trying to do everything, just like the simplest of instructions. Like I'd have the ball and like I wouldn't even throw it like 2 inches ahead of me. I'm like, Dougie, just get the ball. I just want him to have success, just victory. Just put your clamp your mouth on the ball and give it to me. And he wouldn't do that. So I just don't know. I always said I never knew how to teach stuff. So I don't know how to teach him that. How did you teach him to, when you throw the ball, he'd run
what
and
ball
get it?
Use?
The, that, that one with, you know, that red spiky looking one. It doesn't light up anymore though. I couldn't find the green one. Or
it's
okay, in the car?
No, in the yard. He plays with it and he plays the snow.
Okay, and the yellow tennis ball one. I couldn't find that. So yeah, but he wouldn't run for the ball today. Okay, he'd be doing it for attention. They also said anxiety. They said that, you know, anything with change, like Tay has been going to work, that's a change. Jay's over here, you know, now, and that's new to him, you know, like the distraction of that, a lot of excitement. He's just like overly excited with that. So I don't know. There could just be a lot of change in his life now, in the structure. So I don't know. But no, he really is doing exactly what he wants to do. Okay, that's exactly Keisha. Hey girl, how she said she would pick him up and run him outside. That's you. Okay, when I couldn't watch him, he was in his crate. Okay, yeah, seriously, that's what I did today. He has like he has nap times, translation, my nap time, because he just really, really, really is a handful. But I think it's like when you have a child, it's like 24 hour watch, and it's like the parent's more potty trained than the child is. And I feel like that, and I just feel like we take up the bathroom literally almost like every hour on the hour. It's like that too much. He really is the cutest dog ever, though.
Hey, Doggy had toys in the hallway.
I think I gathered them all up. I think they're in the pile. I thought they were dirty or something because
in the laundry.
Yeah, they're upstairs. I think at the head of the stairs. They were just like there. I didn't know why you had them out there like that. I don't know if they had to be cleaned or something. Oh, good. You ordered some products, Kim Gregory, after watching our reviews.
Okay.
That's a good idea. Talk to the vet. Definitely.
Okay.
Oh, every hour, Keisha said, and then you can do every two.
Lori ASMR, he'll be old enough to roam around the house when we can trust him to not pee and poo everywhere.
Roam around the house.
He's only, what, like 8 months right now? And there is no roaming free.
Yeah.
Anywhere.
No, not the way, like, the way you have to just watch him. And because he's a puppy and he does have accidents, and I'm not trying to have my house look a mess.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I really credit people that can do that. Bring a dog home and the dog just runs free. Like, I don't know how they do it. Like, I would be a nervous wreck. I am a nervous wreck. Like, I'm just not going to have him all over, because I know, like, number one, the destruction. You know, we saw that early on. And now this new thing with the going to the bathroom and just not bothered by it. So I just can't have that free roaming like that until he's actually trained.
Yeah.
So
has anybody set up their, I'm out of breath. Has anybody set up any of their Christmas stuff yet? If you celebrate Christmas or any type of decorations that you, for the holidays that you celebrate, does anybody celebrate something other than Christmas here? You put up trees, or does anybody celebrate Hanukkah or Kwanzaa or?
Okay. So yeah, Keisha said nobody can do that with a puppy.
Someone said no, not
just
yet.
Let him run free like that. Yeah. I mean, like, we have like all like these different things. Like, he has a crate. Okay. That's his crate. That's the crate. But then we have kind of like, you know, when you have kids, you have like a playpen. So like, we have like these play yards, these huge things. In the kitchen, it's bigger, so it's this huge area. And then we have one upstairs in my room, so that when he's up there, then it has like a little bit more confining, but it's still there. But all of this just like roaming free from room to room, like, no, definitely not. That's not happening.
He ran into, when my dad was here, I think dad gives him more freedom than we do. When my dad's here, because he's like just kind of like downstairs, like he'll just let him like run around or whatever. And so he ran into the bathroom and like drank out of the toilet. And I was like, oh my gosh, like, oh, that's such a dog thing. Like, no, we don't do that. Like,
I think it's because in Colorado, he has a dog that's like 15 years old. Well, their needs are different. So a 15-year-old dog can go to the bathroom maybe once or twice a day and be okay. So, like, he's never seen a dog go. He goes, he has to go again. We're like, yeah, he has to go again. He's like, I've never seen a dog go to the bathroom so much. Like, we don't know, because we've never had a dog. So I'm like, this is, like, just his schedule. So we'll take him out, and then Jay will think, okay, that should be it for a couple of hours. Let him, like, roam free. And I'm like, are you kidding? No way. I'm like, he's going to go, like, in another hour. We'll, like, the doggy come here. We're like, he's like, where are you taking him? I'm like, back outside.
But I'm wondering, because, like, we don't let him, like, roam or whatever. Like, I know one of the training things was, like, use, like, bells or something, and, like, the dog will touch the bell when he has to go to the bathroom. Like, but we don't put him anywhere, like, near the door. Like, we don't let him, like, roam around where he could touch bells. Like, how does he let us know he has to go to the bathroom? And so, like, in our minds, okay, every hour take him out. But, like, how, you know? It's tricky. It's hard. This is hard. Yeah, wisdom is better. Absolutely not. I picked him up. I was like, oh, my gosh, dog, but we don't do that. We don't drink out of toilets.
Oh,
I'm like,
no,
ah!
No.
And then
he's
trying to, like, turn around and lick my face. I'm like, ah, like, don't lick me. I'm like, gross.
I know.
I couldn't believe it. Like, he went running in the bathroom, and all of a sudden, like, we all stopped, and we heard, like something was drinking. I'm like, what's he drinking? I'm like, I ran in there, and, like, he was, like, in the toilet, like, drinking water. I'm like, oh, my gosh, you have a whole dog bowl. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Like, no.
Yeah. No, it's kind of like I say, like, mothers that watch kids, and then you, like, leave the child with the father, and the child does all kinds of things, you know, with the father that they would definitely not be doing with the mother. So if we were watching him, the door would be closed, so he wouldn't even have access to the bathroom, you know, and all this running free in the house. And, like, I don't mean to be, like, want to be a wet blanket, but all this running free, all this freedom, you know.
Yeah, running on couches.
You got,
a brand new rug, and of course he christened it already.
Right, yeah.
And it was just like,
and on my watch, he never would have been on that. But, you know, you don't want to be like a nag and, like, miserable. Like, oh, let the puppy have fun because he's so cute, and you just look like we're so miserable. But, like, we know him better than Jay does, because he's not used to him. So we know what he's capable of doing. So we just have to just be a little bit more careful. But no, he definitely loves when he's here, because he knows he can cut the fool.
Let me see, is it Rhine 44? Hello, ladies. Love you both so much. Today's my birthday, and I had to get home to see her live. Hashtag 52. Happy birthday!
Oh, 52!
Are you 52?
Yes, girl.
Oh, okay.
This is what 52 looks like.
Okay.
Where is it at?
Girl, at the bottom, girl, where you're probably not.
Oh, okay.
Actually, I am.
Oh, you are, girl?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Thursday. Let's see.
Girl, why can't you see if your glasses on? Right?
I'm looking for the name that you said. You said right?
Right here.
44. Oh, okay.
Right here.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Oh, guys, what's Doggy doing? I put him right there.
What's the medical problem? That he keeps going to the bathroom? I don't think so. I think he's just a puppy untrained.
But we should still maybe ask them for tips. They know
golden doodles. Oh, yeah, tips, but I don't think it's a problem. And let them know, money.
Yeah, and let them know, like how we handle him, because we don't let him roam free in the house. Although, yeah, it is a plus that I would say he's crate trained. Like,
oh, yeah. He won't mess up his stuff.
Yeah, but, like, before we put him in there at any point other than at night to go to sleep, he would bark and freak out. But mm-hmm. now, like, he takes naps during the day. We can put him in there, and he will be silent, and he will go to sleep. And I just love that so much.
Yeah, this new thing is, like, really odd. So now, like, he's on his leash. And if we attach his leash, say, to the pull thing, you know, when you're pulling out a drawer, put it there just temporarily, so like we can clean up his area for another accident.
Yeah.
He just freezes in place. He doesn't move forward. He doesn't move back. He doesn't move to the side. It's like he's petrified. Like Doggy, like you can move. Like the leash is just
so like his crate, his like pen's in the kitchen, and like while his pen is drying, so I had to wipe it down with like wipes or whatever to clean his area. I like put him on a leash and like basically tie him to like the kitchen drawer, and so he's just kind of like in the kitchen moving back and forth. But he, I don't know, something about just being
in a very small area.
Being tied to like a cabinet, he just like freezes. Even though he knows his leash, he knows the kitchen, but something about being attached to the cabinet, he like won't. I'm sure he'll get used to it. Because that's going to be the new thing. Because when I'm trying to, like, clean his pen, it's like, where do I put him? I'm not putting him down on the floor so he can run all around the house. I'm like, I need him to be somewhere. And so right now his area is drying. And so he's just there doing good boy things, I hope.
Yep. Okay, they said eventually he'll go to the door.
Does he have food to eat throughout the whole day? Yeah, mm-hmm. he does. So when we first got him, I was like, you know, in the morning, you know, like 8 o'clock, 12 o'clock. 4 o'clock or whatever like that. But now I just always like just kind of leave food there. I think the vet said he's like a grazer.
Yeah, they said the breed, the doodles,
he used to freak out. I'm like, he's not eating breakfast, he hasn't eaten lunch, but like he eats kind of when he wants to eat. And so
it's some days they won't eat at all, and other days they may eat.
What's he doing?
But he's just playing with a toy.
Oh, okay. I'm sure he's not ripping wood and stuff.
Yeah, no. So, yeah, some days his whole tray of food will stay there. He won't touch it. And then other days he'll come down and just ravenously eat. So,
Gregory, that's different.
What's
that? She said, what's for Christmas dinner? Do y'all do traditional? We're having nachos and making a pot of chili, and we are having hot dogs. That's cool. Fun.
Yeah, the ours is pretty, like, laid back.
Yeah, I feel like Thanksgiving is, like, the traditional one, like, the soul food, that mm-hmm. kind of thing. But, like, Christmas, it could be kind of whatever. I think one year you made one, maybe I'm thinking of Easter. You make pork chops, and that's the Easter, right?
Or like sometimes we would even put the grill out, even though we're in Connecticut and it is freezing and there's snow on the ground. But when we had like a working grill, we put steaks on the grill one Christmas, because mm-hmm. All you have to do is just have access to it. And but I think the grill's like old now. But it's never anything really big or formal. But that sounds great, tacos.
Tacos.
That's we did that
New Year's.
New Year's 1 year.
I want a taco boat so bad.
And you got them.
I did. They're like the tortillas and like a little boat. And I was like, I want a taco boat. They were so good. It was so funny. And that year, like, I don't know, like I was like, I want to bring in the new year with like a glass of wine and this and that. And so like I went out and bought like my favorite wines or whatever. And I didn't drink like any of them because that was the year I think you started making Shirley Temples, and you brought enough for you and Adam. But like, I was like, I want some too. Yeah. And like, I didn't even touch anything I had because like you were making Shirley Temples and they were so good.
Because I don't drink alcohol. So I figured I would do the Shirley Temple. You guys know, I think we did it last New Year's on live. We did that. Mm-hmm. And so I figured like the little grenadine, the little ginger ale mixed together, that would just be like little me and Adam's bringing in the new year. So throughout the night. And then you were dating someone at the time, and that everybody's gonna be like drinks all around. So I'm like, okay, you guys do that, and I'll just do this. And next, you know, like they were just like, oh, what is that over there? And pretty soon they downed the ginger ale, downed the grenadine. It was barely enough for all.
Yeah. Millie, that's a really interesting question that you should ask that. Millie Roman, she said, Taylor Ann, does your hair shrink in the back to the point that it appears shorter than the rest of your hair, even though it's not? I need help with this problem that just started. My hair definitely does that. And even like stylists, like they don't know why it does that. But the front of my hair, like this part is definitely longer. I wonder if it shows. Like, let me see if I flip around. Hold
on, girl, help me.
Okay.
So like, let me see. But it's always like this part, like here. I don't know. It might have been evened out, but it's pretty. This part right here.
Yes.
Always. It's always shorter, like straight down.
Mm-hmm.
Is always shorter.
Yeah.
And then the sides grow longer. I don't know why that is. I don't wear like excessive buns. I mean, obviously I sleep on the back of my head, but like, I don't know. Cause when we went to, Joe Ortiz in New Jersey, he was like, so we were sitting in the chair for like 20 minutes and he was just like grilling me, asking me questions. Like, do you do this? Do you do that? Do you do this? You do that? He's like, I don't, like, we couldn't figure out why my hair grows like that. And that's just the way it grows. And I think when I first got my hair cut by Nubia in New Jersey at Utopia Salon, I think she cut it to whatever length that was. That was the length.
Okay.
It went straight there because the sides were long and the middle part was like there. Let's see if I can find a picture of the back of my head. It was busted. But she, that was the length she cut it to. But the middle part of my head is always shorter and I don't know why that is.
And Gregory said they'll make sugar cookies too. You made sugar cookies tonight.
I did. See?
Show them.
Made little sugar cookies and I put some little frosting on them. Whoop, there they go.
And I had the food coloring upstairs doing my DIY toning. So I shouted down, so I'm like, hey, if you need the food coloring, but you had already frosted
like,
the
girl.
Yeah, the cookies.
It's a little too late.
Yep, but I sure did. Hey, what's your favorite wine?
I like this wine. It's like a red wine. It's called Roscato. And I tried it one time at Olive Garden and was kind of like hooked ever since. It's my favorite. It's like a sparkling red wine. It's called Roscato and it's so good. Love it.
Okay, let's see. Mia Love said, do you know Raven Elise TV? You look just like her, Taylor. Do we know Raven Elise TV?
We love her.
Tonight we were like, when you looked on just before we were going to go on, you're like eight people. We're like, if this room doesn't fill up, we're saying goodbye and we're going to watch Raven Elise. Because she's decorating now the rest of the house,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. She's decorating. Because we just saw her go shopping and now we're seeing her. Decorating, actually doing her decorations.
I was in Target the other day and you're like,
you thought you were Raven Elise TV.
You're like, mom, you buying all this stuff because Raven Elise? I'm like, no, I'm not buying all that stuff.
We had just seen her do her Christmas shopping, like decor for her house. And like, you literally watch her for like decor ideas because like she's good at decor.
Yeah.
And
even though hers is more modern and mine is definitely rustic
and
country.
Is rustic,
Yep. So yeah, so we're just like dragging our feet, even though, you know, I was the main one saying, oh, we're going to get it, put our tree up like mid-November. We still haven't put it up yet. This is like not a good sign because I know we're going to drag. But definitely, we were supposed to get it today, but now we are really like going hard, like working out. This is was it our fifth day?
Fifth day of working out.
Fifth day.
So we've thrown that in the mix.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. So now there's YouTube, there's teaching, there's working out, there's
Yeah, so we're
jogging,
trying to do that because I'm trying to get a handle on this before the holidays get a handle on me.
Getting a handle on them handles.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, no, guys, like normally I'm transparent. Like I ain't going to be transparent about this, but like I saw it creeping up. I definitely saw it creeping up. I just didn't know how much creeping up it had done. So when I saw that, I'm like, no, this is where I have to catch it. You know, when you only have like a few pounds to lose, you know, anywhere from like 10 to 20, like nail it then. Because when you let it go beyond that, it's hard. It's already hard enough as it is.
Mm-hmm.
So I stopped it on a dime after Thanksgiving. Maybe that's why I stopped after Saturday.
You did.
I'm like, I'm
we
done.
Had all that food and you make me feel bad. Like, because I'm like, can you share on a plate with me? Just keep eating plates with me. And you were like, no, I'm done.
I'm done.
Yeah, so.
No, because it'll creep up. And so I was like, okay,
Say Dairy Annie and Francisco. Can you girls say happy birthday to my mom? She's a big fan of you. What's your mom's name?
Aww.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
More birthdays in the house.
Who said that, Dairy Annie?
Dairy Annie Francisco. It's her mama's birthday. Birthdays are fun.
Birthdays are fun.
I'll be 27 this year. 2020. Oh my God. Has anybody been doing the decade challenge? I feel like we don't look that different. Well, except both of our hair was like relaxed.
Yeah, all right. So I have three choices. All right, let me Tate picked them out last night. Let me show you guys. This is like the extra stuff you get when you come online. All right,
yeah,
hold on.
The decade challenge.
The decade. So she picked them out for me and she goes, anything I pick, you gotta say no. So I didn't put them out there
yet. Yeah, because you were like, I don't want to do it like you do it. And I'm like, well, anything I pick, I'm like, you're gonna be like, nee, 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 nee. But you actually didn't.
Okay. All right, so this was one of the selections. Oops. I think gingerbread. No, that's, hold on.
Girl, why is there gingerbread on the screen?
Because they're so cute. I got them off my mother's cage. Okay. All right, so one of the selections. All right. Oh, yeah, you could show it up there.
Okay, so this was one. So this is 2009 versus 2019. Let me see.
That's one.
Wait.
All right, so, yeah.
All right, then the other selections. Light up the next
one. I think were these all the same? Oh, this one I liked.
Okay, that's what you like. That's another selection.
Shout out to relaxers. Girl with the bangs, girl.
Busted. Yeah, so that's I think you just like made them different. One is a little further.
Yeah,
up,
one's
right?
Like closer okay. Up or whatever.
So that's now I'm still shopping for my 10-year challenge photos.
One I found where like, does anybody remember, I guess who's like my age? Like I'm 26, so 10 years ago, like we would have been like sophomores, juniors in high school. There was one picture where like I posed with like my feet turned in like this. It was like feet turned in. I had my fingers like this, and then I had like my cell phone clipped to my belt, and I was like, oh my gosh. I think I had a crop jean jacket and like a slick like bang here. I was like, this is just like so 2009. It's awful. So awful. I couldn't believe it.
I look the same, you think? Maybe in the face, kind of, sort of. I don't know. You think I do?
Yes.
People say that anyway.
You look like you.
Even when I'm a child, like in school with like little braids, two little braids, you're like, Mom, that's your face. That's your face. It's definitely you.
Yep, that looks like you.
I definitely do too, Millie. I definitely love the curls more.
Okay. All right. And like, we never would have known it. Like, it's so weird, like, because I substitute teach at the high school that I went to. And like when I was in high school, like all I wanted was straight hair. Like all the girls with the blonde hair, like the long, like thick, straight brunette hair, mm-hmm. like all I wanted was straight hair. And so like I would always relax my hair, no matter how much I relaxed it or permed it or whatever, like my hair was never getting like that straight. Like I hated my curls so much. And like now I love my curls so much. And it's so funny, like when I get compliments from like students or teachers, like, oh my gosh, I love your hair and da 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 da. Like when I was in high school, like when I was there, like I hated my hair. Like curls was not the thing back in like 2008, 9, 10, 11 when I was there.
I think it's a complete journey because you have to know how to work it. You know, like tonight my hair is just like kind of like just hanging there. But because I know what to do, this will dry and I know how to pick it out. I'll know how to like stretch it if I have to. So it's not a simple matter of just wetting your hair, jumping in the shower, shampooing, conditioning it, or co-washing it and putting in a style. Like you have to know how to work with your hair. And this is like 10 years in the making, mm-hmm. right? Basically.
And like we just like fell into it because what? Mm-hmm. I dyed my hair and permed it in like the same week and it like completely fell out. And then after that, mm-hmm. I was like, okay, no more relaxers, no more dye. Like I can't do anything to my hair but wear it the way it is. And so you see, like my freshman, sophomore year, I had long, stringy, straight, permed hair. And then by my junior and senior year, my hair was just damaged. It fell out. It was busted because mm-hmm. it was damaged. And all I could do, I mean, I didn't even like, I don't know, I was never much of a crier or like a fit thrower. Like, mm-mm. I just started slicking it down and wearing it in a ponytail that had this much hair in it because it fell out.
That's why mine look all sparse because we go through the same journey, it seems like. In those pictures, you said shout out to the bangs or the relaxer. Yeah. But my hair was super damaged
but
there.
But then by like college, like 2012, you kind of started seeing it was like, and we had more of a wave. It had like a big wave. And then by 2013, the spiral started coming. And then by 2014, the spirals got tighter. And then by 2015, it was just coming down. 2016, it was just long and curly and... It basically took from like 2010 to like 2013 to get my hair to spiral. Could go from like waves to like spiral. And then after that, it just like grew down. So, but
Kim Gregory says she has a 26-year-old daughter and a 28-year-old son.
She was a teacher. What does he teach?
Okay. Is Keisha Maldonado still in the room? Because I like so lived her journey throughout the holidays. Like her son came home from the military. That was so me a few years ago. And the excitement when she was putting the post out there. And then to be on, like you had all the young guys in the house, all the military men for Thanksgiving, all of your son's friends perhaps. And I thought that was so cool. And I just remember that year, Spencer couldn't come home for Thanksgiving because he just went there, but he came home that Christmas and it was like the most exciting time just to kind of see like, I mean, like we raised these young men and then like they're serving the country and it was such an honor. So I really felt your excitement. I watched every post. I watched her when she's like, she just dropped her son off and how miserable she was. I mean, I so got it. I mean, it got me like right here. Like I so related to that. He'll be home in 2 weeks. Yeah, exactly. Now that's started with Spencer. He was home more than he was there because he was breaking every bone in his body, and because he went like hard, he went in and he went hard thinking that he could handle it.
And every time I turn around first, I'm like, how do you do that? Like, yeah. Oh my gosh. I'm yeah. Like, ow.
So, and all of the injuries that he had, he easily, they said, could have
discharged.
Absolutely. And then our feet are so flat. Like they said, his feet are so flat. And
y'all's feet.
My feet.
I think yeah. I'm the only one with the arch in the house. Like, I'm like, yeah. I can't relate to y'all no. at all.
Our feet are so flat that his feet are so flat that that easily could have gotten out of serving. And no, but he stayed there and wait till you go to the graduation. So after, he graduated and then AIT. Have you seen the graduation yeah. yet? Like that graduation, that music, those soldiers coming out of that smoke. I don't know. Like I thought that was maybe like something like special for his graduation, but maybe they all do it. Cause when I've talked to other Army moms, they've seen that. But have you seen that graduation yet? When they had that music and then all the guys, like first you see all the smoke and then like you see them all marching, like maybe column A and then B, then C, then D, and then you see them getting close. Oh my God.
We have a vlog, guys. What is it?
So, yeah, it's like, gotta see that graduation.
Go to our vlogs, it's like we go to South Carolina. I think there's two of them. There's two vlogs. We go to South Carolina
yes,
and Georgia.
It's in Georgia. Have you seen yeah. it? You went to his graduation?
Where is it? Amina said, oh my God, I graduated high school in 2010. I'm thinking about planning my high school reunion. Do it. I know my class was so eager. They did a 5-year reunion. And like, I can't believe how much our lives changed in 5 years. I definitely had to go. I was like, because I was busted leaving high school and I got to roll up sickening this 5-year reunion. So I went and it was a good time. So I totally know our class president's going to do. It's gonna do 10 years.
Really have rough lives. You pointed out somebody the other day, you said he was in your class. He didn't have any hair on his head, but you could see that he wanted, because you know how like when men are balding and it's like around here, he's in your class. I'm like, you've gotta be kidding me.
You're like, I thought that was somebody for me. I'm like, that man's my age.
And then you're like, no, he was in my class. I'm like, which one was he? Like, anyway, of course, I'm not giving names. But like, what do people do? You're like my grandmother used to say, they look like they wore two sets of bodies. Yeah, like,
no.
Wow.
No, me and Spencer's classes, yeah. 2010, 2011, it's some hard living. I mean, yeah. after 5 years, I'm like, y'all partying, drinking, acting crazy in college. I'm like, you know, you look like it.
I'll tell you, like link the video in there because Rochelle hasn't seen it and she loves to see soldiers.
Okay.
It is such a cool video. And do I have the what's it called when you bring them to the exact spot? Like I always would play it over and over again and then burst out crying and then play it over again and burst out crying. Gross. I'm so proud of my son. I mean, it is just so awesome. I love it.
You're so funny.
Excuse Taylor and all of her busted screaming, ruining the moment. Be able to hear the music.
You're lucky I got the footage because you were trying to Facebook bust it live and bust it. And then my dad bought a camcorder that died the second he turned it on.
I know, we were thankful for you. I know, like, we were thankful for the footage.
I was the only person that had footage.
I know, because if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have had it.
Oh wait, I think the graduation.
There's 2 days, it was Saturday.
So there's the traveling Fort Jackson family day.
Right.
Which one was family day? Might have been the one. Yeah,
it might have been the one, the family day, because then the next day was the actual graduation. It was family day, not the graduation. The graduation was a little bit more formal, and they have on their dress blues and all of that.
Okay. I just linked it there.
But no, the graduation.
But
is
if you go
Saturday.
To our playlist vlogs, I think there's like 21 vlogs listed.
Yeah.
If you scroll down to vlogs, it will say part one, part two. There will be vlog traveling Fort Jackson SC family day. And then part two says Fort Jackson Army graduation, Charleston, South Carolina, and Fort Gordon, Georgia. And that's, excuse our bustedness in the video. Because we definitely look crusty. The first day we opened the vlog, like I look like an egg. Like, just busted.
You'd be a good boy.
And, yeah, it's our traveling. Yeah. It's
Saturday when you meet, it's family day. And that's when you have a senior soldier. And all that time, and we hadn't seen Spencer forever because he was there, he just kept breaking bones. Every now and then he'd come back, but finally he was there, finally it was graduation day, and then that was the first time we saw him after all those months. And when they played that music and all that smoke came up and all those soldiers came out and all that smoke, oh my gosh, what a moment, what a proud mother, you know, what a proud moment.
Jerissa Coleman wants to know what your chapstick is since you're going to town on it.
Oh, okay, this is for my, I told y'all it's a beautification night, okay? This is Ole Henriksen. It's so cute, it's like so fall, it's apple. And I keep doing it like that because it's like exfoliating. So it's Lucky Pucker, it's called Ole Henriksen. And it smells like, apple, like, falls. But I was like, apple, where's the lid to it? I don't know.
Oh, it's back here. Oh, there it is.
Okay. Yeah, so it's so cute.
Quick one second, I actually saw, but... Oh, he teaches computer science, 5th through 8th. Cool, okay. Computer science.
Yeah, so that's it right there. And it's called Lucky Pucker, and it smells like apple.
I don't know. I think teaching is such a great profession. I love it. I enjoy it so much. I love being back in the school districts.
I know. I think it's so cool.
I think I'm the only one. Like, some teachers are just like, and I'm just like, hi, good morning. Have a great day.
Yeah, so there it is right there.
I'm not burnt out yet.
Here. And here's the box. Oops. It's right there. So, a little something I picked up. I didn't pick up anything. Sephora didn't have sales. Sephora had their big VIB sale weeks before Black Friday. So, they had a few, like, things, but nothing like I would want, like the skincare and all that. I did all that shopping during their VIB sale. No, there was no live last week. The week got away from us. And...
It did. No, seriously, because I think the last year we went to my grandma's for Thanksgiving, and this year we had it here, and like it was just a lot of work. It was just a lot of cleaning, a lot of cooking, a lot of doggy, a lot of hosting, a lot of me trying to fit in hours. Like I feel like I left you hanging with some of the cooking. Like, yeah. It was a lot.
And normally I have you to do the prep. I think we talked about it before Thanksgiving that I saved time getting the collard greens chopped up from our grocery store. I probably wouldn't do that again. I'm going to go back to the old way. This year, those bags were, like, awful. I was picking out more of those, like, those stalks
but
and everything.
But you seasoned them to perfection,
because
though.
I found a way to make them.
They
like,
were
I didn't,
so good.
I didn't realize, like, all right, so once you fry up the salt pork, and I think I was, like, running short of time. I was getting really, really tired. I didn't have you here to help. So I just kind of, like, threw them in with the salt pork, and it almost kind of, like, fried them. And they shrivel down to like that, whereas normally they're like pouring out the pot, and I'm like, I'm diluting the salt pork, and it's just, so I'm like, oh, maybe this is the way you're supposed to do it, like throw the collard greens in with the salt pork and mix it all together, and then put
before
the water
you
in.
Put the water in and kind of like, I mean, maybe the water is like diluting all like the seasoning like up front or something, like I don't know. They definitely tasted different this year. They were amazing.
They really were. So I didn't have like your help there. I was just super tired, and so even like the day of Thanksgiving, even though all the guys said they would help us and all that, it's just like, no, we'll
and then
do
like
it.
The cleanup, it took us like almost 2 days to clean up, because like we tried, like the boys just were like thanks and like disappeared, like
no, but I just said like they said like they would help us, but it's just like, because we knew like everything had to go,
yeah,
so though we could like delegate and dictate,
it's just by the time you're done delegating, it's like I could have just done it
myself.
So like, it took us like 2 days to clean up
because
it was just a lot, but we did it. Girl.
We did it. Like,
girl.
2 days. Like first,
it was
like,
nice.
First, it just seemed overwhelming. We're like, where did all this food come from?
Where
did
all
this? You know, like, after you eat, like you're just like, oh, it was just a lot. And so first, we started off with getting a piece of key lime pie.
Right. We had to get our lives first.
We had to sort things.
And then
out.
We had to start tackling the table and like getting like the what is it the to-go container kind of things. And
let me see. Amina said Sephora had 15. You know what Sephora does? Sephora had $25 off of, I think, maybe 100, maybe? Yeah, what am I waiting for from Sephora? I did get something the other day, because I saw that. I'm like, okay, this is equivalent to like a VIB. What did I get? Because I know I did get something recently from Sephora. And what I should have done, and I thought like, oh, it'll be around, hopefully it'll come back, Clarisonic. Remember how Tay got me Clarisonic a few months ago? And like now the heads, they said every 3 months. I don't know, does anyone have a Clarisonic? Because I know that they show like the little dark mark when it's time to change. So the Radiance brush is like showing the dark mark, but the exfoliating one doesn't even have an area for that. And I wanna get the pore one, which is like the blue one. But I'm thinking, do you have to change them like that? But anyway, they were $15 at Sephora on Black Friday. And I didn't take advantage of it because I'm thinking, oh, it'll be there. But it's not there. They went right back up to $27. So hopefully that will come back around. Oh, $25 off of the $75. Okay. Then I definitely took advantage of that one. And I'm trying to think, what did I get at Sephora the other day that I'm waiting to come in the mail? Let me check my order. I have so many things out there. I have to check these orders. I said, like, you know, I think there was a cute little post I put on my Facebook page that, you know, stay home is like the best savings to stay home is save 100%. I'm like, are you kidding me? If you stay home, like, all you do is click. You're just a click away from shopping.
No,
click.
No,
click,
online shopping click. Is so much more dangerous than in-store shopping.
It is, yeah.
No, it really is.
Yeah, no, I was doing some serious online shopping.
All when I was asleep.
Girl, I don't have to, I'm not scared of you, girl.
Boxes are coming in, you're running boxes.
Who else is far sighted beside me and Lori, right? I'm far sighted.
You're far sighted?
Yeah.
Like you can't see close up, right? Maybe too far away. Me, I'm nearsighted, so I can see close, but like if I were to take my contacts out, I can't see like hands in front of my face.
I can see there. I can see across the room. I can't like maybe read things, but I can see. But yeah, no, I definitely need reading glasses. I don't know what that's considered. I know, Veronica Glover said, I stayed home and spent lots more. I did. It was dangerously more, I said. Let's see what I got from Sephora.
Yeah, no, my sight is so bad. If I take my contacts out, like, I couldn't see this iPad sitting right here.
Mm-hmm.
My sight is so bad.
I had a Radiance head and changed them every 6 months. I don't go by what they say. Okay. All right, because that, like, tonight I was thinking, it looked like I had to. Well, actually, it did look like I had to change it. I just felt like I got it back in August. So I'm thinking August, September, October, November, December. So it's been 4 months. And I'm thinking, really? Seriously? You know, I didn't think they just want my Manny.
Manny.
So every 6 months. Okay, that sounds reasonable.
Manny.
And what about the other ones? Like the exfoliating one. There's one for pores. Then there was one that like cashmere for like soft on your skin. I mean, there's so many now. I just hate when there's like a lot of selection, but you know, I'm happy with the Radiance one. Nope. I'm staying away from Ulta. Nope. I paid down that Ulta card that I got last month. That's it for me. Like cash and carry.
Lovely. Are any Christmas related videos coming? Yes. So we want to decorate our Christmas tree with you guys, like we did last year. So this will be our probably like our live, because we know when we do the Christmas decoration one, it gets demonetized because we play Christmas music. So
well, we gotta be probably doing it again alive again this weekend because I am not waiting.
That's what I'm
week.
Saying.
Okay.
Girl, I didn't say you had to. Busted that.
Girl, I'm ready to go.
Girl.
You wanna catch these hands, girl?
She was getting ready to like fight me. I didn't say you had to.
Every time I want to do something, it always has to be content. I'm like, I'm tired of doing content. Can I just live my life? What did I want to do the other day? And I'm like,
sorry, got so upset. Like,
I
didn't
want
say
to do
anything
the other day
yet.
That you're just like, that should be a video. I'm like, I'm tired.
Because she was decorating the house for Christmas. And I'm like, why don't we vlog like your decorations?
I'm like, no.
Because for months she's been buying Christmas decorations, and now you're like putting them up, even though there's like nothing here. We haven't. We're decorating this, right? Is this gonna be decorated? Is this it?
You know, I never really thought about that. Like, I concentrate on that area. Remember, we brought the party out there last year. Okay, so like, the tree is there.
Okay.
We want to sit by the tree, so we brought it out there.
But so we buy the tree, and then we let it has to. It takes like a day or so to like the leaves to fall.
Yeah,
and or the pines or whatever. And then we're gonna decorate our tree with you guys. So we want to do that. And then you guys want to see what we got for Black Friday. But other than that, I think it's mostly just gonna be our award ceremony kind of videos this month. You know, our top brands, top products of 2019, our disappointing products. Well, we got to get in funeral mode. The all black, and we should do an ugly Christmas sweater challenge.
That's cute. Who said that?
Wisdom is better. She always comes with all the wisdom.
That's cute.
Look at the ideas.
Yeah. I think like, we do cuter ones than you could ever buy in the store.
You
had such a cute one year.
Oh my gosh. No, I did. And we went to a family like Christmas party. And I think we all won because it was me, the guy I was dating at the time, and you.
Me.
And we all like went to Michael's. We bought stuff. We were here like making our sweaters. Mine was like the best one overall.
Mm-hmm.
Like for like, mine was just the best one overall. I won.
Won that.
You won like
for
vintage.
The most original.
Original. Yeah. And then what was his? Like the most classic or something. His sweater was like really like vintage.
Yeah.
Kind of. It looked really like thrift store vintage.
Yours
and then
was
he put
so
stuff
cute.
On it.
Like you had it in your mind.
I did.
And I enacted it on the sweater.
I want.
Yeah. What? Girl, I'm creative. I did.
Girl, you didn't make my sweater.
Guys,
you didn't make my sweater. Girl, you didn't make my sweater.
The second, maybe
the first year you made my sweater. When I was student teaching at the time, you made that sweater.
Trying to take all
but
the
then
credit.
The second year, I said I wanted. Whew, girl. The second year, I wanted a giant tree on it. You didn't do the giant tree.
I did. Who did it?
I did.
Did you?
Yeah, I did.
The first year, when they lit you up, they set you on the bar, and then they lit you up. Those dangerous lights from, like, back in the 50s, you know, those great big light bulbs. It was so cute. Where's your picture of that? That was all me. I stayed up all night long. Maybe that's where I'm thinking of that one.
We need to buy a gingerbread house. I just saw that comment. So we can do a gingerbread, like, do some Christmas activities.
Yeah, in our vlog, we were there. The vlog where I was almost going to be sex trafficked. Who was laughing at me?
You had
that?
Just read that, like, sex trafficking is at an all-time high, and then all of a sudden you run into sex traffickers. I'm like, okay, well.
I did.
Okay.
Thank God I was woke. Thank God
they
I was woke.
They want you.
Guys, should take it seriously. I'm telling you. But you're saying that people
there's my sweater.
Okay, that's the year. Okay, that's so cute.
Yeah, no, this was
the one she did.
This was the one, and, like, I won, like, the best, like, sweater at the party or whatever. I think I won a gift card or a bottle of wine or a bottle of something. I did, like, my makeup. It was green and red, and then I had the bow, and then I made my sweater from scratch. Like, I made the tree and, like, all the things on it. I took, like, present wrap, like, those things you stick on presents, and put it around my neck like a collar. Oh, my gosh. Best sweater ever. I love that sweater so much.
Yeah, no, that was really cute.
Where's yours? This was yours. Yours was more, like, vintage.
Yeah, I just took...
I don't know. It had, like, patches and stuff on it.
Yeah, because, like, I didn't want to get those ones that, like...
And it had, like, bows and, like, patches and just different things. So fun.
That's a cute idea, Sarah. She said, what about a gingerbread house decorating video while we talk about hair products? It could be a lot. That's a cute idea.
That's fun. We said we were going to...
We went to Target and...
We wanted to do that.
We took it out the cart, though, because things was getting pricey.
We did.
What about the first year, though?
You know when, like, you see your cart, you see the price start going up, you start thinking of things you can take out. It's like, we'll take out these $3 pair of gloves. This was the first year when I was student teaching. My mom, okay, this was the sweater Lorianne made that kicked it off. And I had lights wrapped around me. And basically everywhere I went in the school that year, they, like, wanted to plug me into a wall and light me up because my sweater lit up. And I had a tree skirt around my neck.
Yeah, that was a tree skirt. Like,
so
like
you made that
tree.
One.
That was so cute.
And then the next year we went to a party. And I made
love
my sweater. But this year, if we get to go to a party, I want a snowman on mine. I want, like, I have to get, like, gigantic, like...
Oh, you want a snowman?
Yeah.
That's cute.
But it has to be, like, 3D. Like, I want it, like, protruding off me, like a big snowman.
I get it. Yeah, I totally get that. That's
so
cute.
Yeah, I'm like, wear a little snowman hat. Like, girl.
That's cute.
All of that. So if I get the opportunity. I didn't get it last year because there were no parties, but our cousins, like, they throw, like, lit parties. They didn't do it last year, but if they do it this year, like, you know, I'm going to go so I can wear a sweater.
That's a cute idea. Or you should do a reaction to what you're watching on your crime channels. That's a great idea.
So did anybody watch, speaking of reactions and stuff, the Red Table Talk with Jada Pinkett and T.I. and Tiny? Did anybody watch that? And what he had to say?
Wait, Lisa Powell said, keep your points from Sephora. One of the employees said next year they will change their point system and let you purchase things like Ulta. Oh, okay. Because I think I have close to 6,000 points now.
I didn't see it, but some stuff on the Shade Room. The Shade Room keeps us all up to date. Although the comment section is horrible in the Shade Room.
He was so arrogant. Absolutely.
Yeah, he said that he was exaggerating or whatever, and people took him, like, literally, like...
He's backpedaling. Yeah.
I mean, I just like listening to Jada. I think she's just so so intelligent. Like, I'm just like, like, I love listening to her talk. She was trying, though, but T.I., it was above her now.
Yeah,
it was above her.
She had a lot to work with.
Yeah.
Part one, we both saw, and then part two, we saw part of it. We still have to finish watching
the
end of it.
We have to finish the rest of it, but yeah, no. Yeah, T.I. and Tiny, like, busted.
I won't watch it. I heard all I need to hear. The crawly K-pop. He's a narcissist, yeah. I know, I feel bad for Tiny. She's trying to have a little voice, poor thing, but you could see that he definitely is not allowing it. She feels a little empowered because she's there, Jada's there. She feels like Jada might have her back. But, yeah, like, that ride home probably is not going to be pleasant.
I saw Seraphine and Jada went too soft on him. I think Jada had to find the balance. Like, he's, like, a guest on her show.
Mm-hmm.
And it would have been, like, three women against this one guy. Like, so I think she kind of had to find, like, a balance. Because it wasn't about, like, attacking him. It was just about having a conversation about why he said what he said. Like, explain yourself. She wasn't there to scold him. It was more, like, school him and teach him or whatever. You don't want to be abrasive to, like, the person mm-hmm. who... You know,
I didn't like the familiarity, in all honesty. Okay. I just didn't care for this tip.
Everybody
tip.
Calls him Tip.
Yeah, but like, that's her husband, and I don't like all this Tip. You stay with Will and let me have T.I. or Tip.
But
or
everybody calls him Tip.
Yeah, what's his real name?
What's his real name?
Okay. I just felt it was too familiar.
But even like in rap songs, his name is Tip.
Okay. I felt it was too familiar, and I didn't like things like when she would laugh. Like when you're a woman and you're trying to work through things, you don't need somebody else encouraging the bad behavior. And so when he was doing things and saying things, and she would laugh, you know, along like with him, and I just felt like that was not supporting Tiny. Nor would I want her laughing at anything like Tiny would say against him. Like, just stay neutral. Nothing's mm-hmm. funny. Like, just not have emotion. Like, you're supposed to be the therapist and helping them. So don't encourage his bad behavior. And so there was a point where he laughed. I don't remember what it was. But all this Tip this and Tip that, you know, Tip now you're like reaching out. Tip like, I didn't like that. Like, whatever his professional name is or whatever, call him that.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't like the familiarity. It felt like they were in on something like Tiny wasn't aware of, and as a wife, I wouldn't like that. I don't like.
Oh, okay. I didn't get that vibe.
Yeah, no,
that they were like there was like I just thought like I mean I think everybody knew like T.I. was an idiot, and I think Jada was just trying her best because, I mean, I always thought T.I. was fine, and that's all I really knew about T.I. and like his music. I didn't, but now that I'm actually like listening to him and things that he says and things that he puts out there, I'm like, T.I.'s an idiot. Like, I didn't know
he was. His real name is Clifford?
I didn't know he was an idiot. Like, okay.
Okay.
Wow.
So,
okay.
So then if I was trying to, okay, Jada, like,
I'm like, he is not Clifford. He's not a catch. Like,
yeah. No, he's not.
He's not a catch at all.
I was like, okay, Jada, you know, his name is Clifford, and that's what I like my wow. husband to be addressed.
Who calls him Clifford?
I don't know, that's his name. But all this Tip, this Tip, that is too much familiarity and too like ingratiating for his bad behavior. So I didn't care for that. And you saw Will Smith, he wanted no parts of
Will
that.
Will Smith was out.
Yeah,
and so was like, Willow. She was nowhere to be found.
Nope. Yes, exactly, Veronica Glover. He gave me those vibes, like a bully. Definitely.
I mean, oh, right, yeah. I feel like she laughed. She wasn't laughing with him. It was more like, this guy's like
perhaps, but sometimes busted. People that are narcissists think that you're agreeing with them when you laugh, you're supporting them. So the slightest bit of things that are kind of like supporting them, they think, okay, I'm in. You know, so I didn't like that. He's not a candidate that could appreciate laughter.
Yeah.
Okay, because
and you
take
said
that.
Like T.I. ran like the wind, and I did not know that. I didn't mm-hmm. know he was like cheating on Tiny and stuff, but he came right out there and said it. Like, he came out of jail and he needed to do stuff to make him feel like like a man again. And it's like, okay.
Yeah. Clifford, like, the big nose dog. Yeah, that's the part she laughed at. When Tiny said that she had never slept with anyone else. And then he said, and I never
lied about it or something.
Yeah, and then Jada laughed. Like, that's not funny. Like, I don't. And so something like that is encouraging bad behavior. And that
maybe because
it was funny at all.
It's awkward. Like, it's cringe.
Yeah. Well,
like,
it definitely is not funny. And I don't.
Okay.
Like, there's a thin line between.
But was Tiny laughing? Like,
no, she wasn't. She was poker face. It's nothing to laugh at. Her husband's like running like the wind, and then Jada's like laughing and encouraging it by laughing. So I didn't find it funny at all. I would have just said, you know, you really think that that's funny? You really think that you contributed something?
All
right
I
now?
Know is Tiny came prepared. Her hair was laid. She was not going to the red table talk looking busted. Her hair was laid.
That's true. Laughing made him comfortable to keep digging his grave. Yeah, because he just sounded crazy. Like, he was trying to sound so intelligent. He sounded like a fool. He was just trying to sound like he was just so knowledgeable.
Yeah, the mother was not having it. Like, mm-hmm. she was just not... Yeah.
No.
I don't know. Again, I saw some comments that people were saying, like, the topic was just too big for Jada. Like, she was doing the best she could, but T.I. needs professional help, like, because he's just busted.
That's true. Tiny is trying to stay relevant because when the story started unraveling, they said that she was in some group, band, rapper, whatever. She was trying to have a career. Mm-hmm. Then he talked her into not having a career.
Yeah, she wanted to do music and stuff. And he was like, no, like, I'll take care of you. I'll take care of your family. I'll take care of it all. Like, mm-hmm. you just basically stay home with the kids. And she agreed to that. And I guess now she kind of wants to have, like, a career again. And so he was like, you can't backpedal on things you agreed to. Like, what if I want to backpedal on things? Like, I think he said, what can a man backpedal on? He's like, so you agreed to these terms, and these are the terms, and now you don't want to do these terms anymore. And, like, he was just stuck on, like, that fact. Like,
Chelsea said, but Will and Jada have an open marriage. So, do they? Like, I saw an episode where they were discussing their marriage, and what I gleaned from it was that he is all about his ego, Will, all right? And he did things for Jada that he wanted, like, kind of like the praise for. So she wants to be unassuming a little bit, and he is just, like, big out there, big personality, just really out there. So I think they gave the example of, like, her birthday party, and he planned this great big thing, you know, Mary J. Blige and all these celebrities and all that. And she didn't want that. And she cried. She said she didn't cry because she was happy. She cried because she was so upset that he discounted what she said. She didn't want this huge party. And in this kind of like therapy session, because they were around the round table too. Is it red table, round table? All right.
The red table.
The knights of the round table. Okay. The round table. He admitted that he did it for ego, and she admitted that she likes to be unassuming. Now, this open marriage thing, I didn't really get that. I think that they're at the point in their marriage where they respect each other's boundaries, kind of. Like, she has her life, what she wants to do. She doesn't want to do all that he wants to do, and he's okay with her doing her thing, and she's okay allowing him, like, to do his thing. So I can, like, respect that, you know, because...
Yeah, so I thought the open marriage thing was a rumor. I feel like it probably was. They said that they were swingers or something, but no one ever officially said that. I don't get the vibe Jada plays that game at all.
Yeah, not
I
at
really
all.
Don't.
No.
And then one thing T.I. said was, like, that... or Jada said, like, you know, Horn will have her issue, like, their issues, mm-hmm. and then, like, I think T.I. said or something, but, like, no one ever hears about it, which is true. Will and Jada are, like, aren't really in the press for, like, right. acting the fool, like, arguments and stuff like that. Speaking of acting the fool, Justin Timberlake, what do we think about that? Justin Timberlake and his co-star, I think her name was Alicia something, I don't know, she's a black woman, though, but he was caught holding hands with her at a bar, something, she had her arm, her hand on his knee, and bustedness, and he's married to Jessica Biel, and they've been married for a while. Jessica Biel knows Seventh Heaven. You know, I watched Seventh Heaven.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Where she came from?
Jessica Biel?
Yeah.
Well, I know her from Seventh Heaven. But like they got married, but they married for a while, and they have a kid together or whatever. But no, he was out with pictures being taken of him and the girl, the woman holding hands and bustedness, and finally he came out and made a statement, and he said nothing happened, but clearly, like, from the photos, they're, like, holding hands and stuff.
Wait,
like,
you said Justin who? Bieber?
Justin Timberlake.
Oh, Justin Timberlake.
Justin Timberlake.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Justin Bieber.
No.
And that was the one with the N-word the other day, right?
Yes.
That he got a pass, which I didn't understand that.
We'll get to Justin Bieber in a
Justin
minute.
Timberlake.
Another Justin. Yeah, Justin Bieber's bustedness is coming back around again.
Okay.
But so, Justin Timberlake.
Now, what's the problem? Now, what happened here?
How'd
that thing go?
He's filming this movie. I think it's called Palmers or some type of movie.
Okay.
And he has a pretty black co-star that looks like Alicia Keys.
Okay.
And I think her name, what's her name, Alicia? Alicia? I think her name is Alicia. And they were, like, paparazzi pictures were taken where they were at a bar, I guess, after filming or whatever, and she has her hand on his knee, they're holding hands, they're whispering, da-da-da, blah-blah-blah, and, like, these pictures went everywhere, and he finally came out basically, like, a week or two later saying that he was drunk, nothing happened, and he apologizes to his wife and his family for embarrassing her and da-da-da-da, but... Like, people were like, Justin, like, you were one of the good guys, blah, 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 bust the house, whatever. And,
I'm tired of those lame excuses.
I mean,
was drunk. Like, if you can't hold your liquor, then, like...
Seriously, just, to like, say you were... On. That's what you do when you're under the influence? You, like, touch up on your co-stars? Like, really?
I've never been under the influence. Like, when you're under the influence, are you really out of your right mind? Or do you just pretend to be?
I've never been that under the influence. Like,
I would think that you would still have, like, a little bit of command
of your
presence.
Right.
Like, I mean, are you really that out of it?
They said he had, like...
How much drinking does it take to be that out of it?
He had a couple of beers and tons of shots or whatever,
I would never want to be out of my right mind like that. doggy. Yeah, I don't understand that kind of drinking that you just don't remember a thing. I don't remember.
He said he had too much to drink and he was touching up on his co-star in public.
Like, hey, are you a believer?
I wouldn't say I'm a believer, no. I do listen to Justin Bieber's music. I do have him on my playlist, which brings us around to Justin Bieber. He's apologizing for racism again, even though he apologized years ago. Maybe he's just talking about racism in general, but the Shade Room is busted because I guess he put out some posts about, like, you know, stop racism or whatever, and the Shade Room put it out there, but then they basically were like, you know, remember this when Justin Bieber, like, said this, and it was, like, a video of him when he was 14, and one of his songs is One Less Lonely Girl, and I'm like, oh, I know that song, but he changed the word girl to the N-word with the hard R, and he just kept saying it, and I was just watching this video like, I've never seen this video before, and apparently it went viral a couple years ago, and the Shade Room brought it back to the surface, and I'm like, I guess for people like me who have never seen this before, but he just looked like a little stupid 14-year-old singing his own song, switching the girl to this offensive word. I'm like, what was he thinking? Like, what is this? I've never seen the video before, and it was so busted.
Yes,
I'm like, what is this?
Is it Salika Brown? So Justin should stop drinking ASAP.
I was like,
right,
watching the video, like, oh my gosh, like, how did he even get out of this? And this was years ago. How did he get? And people were like in the comments, like, well, he apologized for this years ago and da da da. I'm like, well, I'm just seeing it now. I'm like, this is crazy. How did he? Yeah. How did he escape with his career after this video? This is crazy.
If I was Justin's wife, yeah, we're gonna have a serious issue. I don't play that. Yeah, I don't think very many people would play that.
She probably did it. Maybe that's why he went out there with a statement. Jessica Biel probably got him. Is still getting him straight behind the scenes.
Alcohol only suppresses your inhibitions. So, what does that mean? Is that when people say that a drunk man speaks a sober man's mind? Is that something like that?
Usher hid the story and the video.
Usher, what?
Well, Usher was kind of like his mentor, of sorts. No, that video.
Exactly, like, drunk actions are sober thoughts. Exactly.
Well, people said Justin Timberlake. So many Justins were talking. Justin Timberlake always liked black women. That's what they were saying. They were like, no, people weren't surprised. But I mean, it's kind of busted where people were like in the comments, like, yes, like, you know, we knew he wanted to be with a black woman. Like, he cheated on his wife. Like, or fine, maybe he didn't cheat. If you don't want, I don't know. I would call it cheating. I'm like, you over there holding hands, letting another woman touch you.
One you showed me the other day, that singer from America's Got Talent or whatever, that American Idol, remember?
Oh, Jordan Sparks.
Jordan Sparks.
Yeah. Oh, guys. I'm sorry. Just so much celebrity news. So Jordan Sparks and her husband, Dana Isaiah, I believe his name is, and he posted a picture of him and this woman, and he's black man, white woman. Not doing anything, but people made it a thing in the comments. One of the things they made in the comments. But basically, I guess they've been friends since high school, and they're in a picture like this. She's like this, and he's like this, just grinning, huge grin.
Yeah.
Grin couldn't be wider. And he said, I think the caption was, he's like, there's only a few people who could get me out of the house.
After
10 at night, 10:30 at night, who could make me smile this big. Like, it was like this caption, and
how
people weren't
disrespectful to his wife. I mean,
but Jordan was in the comments like, you know, you guys are like insecure if you don't think like your man can have friends, real friends, da 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 da. And no one's saying they can't have friends, but like the contact, there was like the physical touch, that embrace. He wasn't wearing his wedding ring. Where was the wedding ring at?
Mm-hmm.
And it was just the caption. The caption made it all just
worse. I didn't like
worse.
The caption, the fact that there's only a few people that can make me smile. I did, like, I didn't care for that, again, the familiarity.
She was
like
just
that.
Hugging him way too tight, grinning, both grins, drinks in front of them. And he's like, you know, there's not very many people who could make me smile like this. Like,
What else could she say? Like, she had to support him because he already, like, was out there. And what could she say?
Like, I don't want to read or, like, hear, like, about another woman making you smile that hard. Mm-hmm. He was grinning. Like, the grin, he looked like the Cheshire Cat. Like,
right, yeah.
It was just a mess.
Yes, busted now.
It was just a mess.
Right, she would have to catch these hands.
And people were like, you know, and Jordan was like, oh, like, you know, I love her so much. She's such a sweetheart, this and that. And people were like, yeah, until she takes your man. Like,
exactly, yeah. Who said that? Ms. La, your wife should be your best friend. Exactly.
Like, having him out past 10:30, mm-hmm. he has a whole baby. Yeah. What are you doing? Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
With drinks, another woman wrapped around your neck, like... Yeah. Even though she's your best friend since high school, whatever.
Yeah, Denise says she's crazy. No, I think it's like she just, what else could she say? He already put that picture out there, you know, so what else could she say?
No one's supporting in public, snapping in private.
Right?
Wisdom is better. A whole baby, not even a half a baby, a whole entire child. Who's very cute, by the way. Very cute. They have a cute kid.
Yeah, just yuck. It's a no. Like, seriously.
She's at home, probably hair wrapped, waiting for him, and he's at the bar, smiling with this woman, saying that's the not very many people can make him grin like this.
Kim Gregory, that's like the choice that you made. She said, my husband and I don't wear wedding rings either. So that's like you both don't do that. But when one does and the other one doesn't, because they made a point of it, wears his wedding ring. So apparently Jordan is wearing hers. And so like his is off like for the night, like, you know, slides on and off like that. So probably that's why. But if you make a decision not to, both of you not to, then that's your decision. But you're not doing it for nefarious reasons. So...
That's it's funny because my boyfriend has a high school best friend before me. I had to ask questions about this girl. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Let's talk about this. Like, I don't know how I feel about, like, besties. Like, I was just never one, like, for that. I feel like there's, somebody has feelings. That's just the way I feel about it. Like, I don't know. Do you feel like men and women can, like, just be friends without, like, feelings getting involved? Like, I feel like somebody always feels some type of way, even if it's just like a little bit, like I don't know. If I met a guy and he was like, this is my female best friend, like so why weren't you guys, why didn't you guys ever date? Like, what's how did
you guys
just
think
become
men
friends?
And women could be,
like,
friends? What could the woman bring to a guy's world that, like, his new girlfriend, fiance, wife couldn't bring? To me is just problematic. Maybe I'm just from a whole other generation, but I just don't go in for that kind of a thing. I just don't.
JRQ said, I've had male friends where there really wasn't any attraction between us, but they also weren't my besties. Where there really wasn't any attraction? Like, maybe you weren't attracted to them, but were they a little bit attracted? Like, was there ever, like, anything, like, flirty? Like, I don't know.
You have a male BFF, but Denisha, do you have a significant other in your life? I could see you having a male best friend if you're not in a relationship. Once you have a relationship, to me, that would be problematic. Men can have all the female best friends they want to, but when you're in a relationship, I think it's just, to me, human nature. And I think that's where it gets muddied. The waters get muddied nowadays because everything's just so accepting and everything is just okay. I think it's extremely problematic when you're in a relationship, a serious relationship, and your husband or your wife has a best friend, so to speak, that's of the opposite sex.
Nicole, I feel it too. Like, that's just how I feel. She said it's a slippery slope.
It is.
I feel like
Absolutely.
It's inevitable that one person has feelings some way, somehow. Like, that's just...
Because why are you going to just be hanging around with somebody so, like, just homely? Like, there's got to be something there. Like, I'm not going to just be in a male's company just best friend. Like, what could that best friend male do for me that a significant other couldn't do? It's a slippery slope, like you said. Mm-hmm. I think it's problematic. And when I think back to the relationships in my family of my older aunts, my grandparents, all of that, they didn't have all of this. I remember one time when my grandmother was alive. Now my grandparents both have passed away. But they were in the church. And my grandmother nailed it. I mean, she nailed it at that point. My grandfather was the deacon, and they wanted him to go give communion on Sundays for those that were, like, the sick and the shut-in. And they paired him with another woman. And my grandmother said, oh, no, 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 no. Absolutely not. She had to have a meeting with the pastor, and she said, no, that would not happen. Now, she could be sitting in the car, because every Sunday, like, they would be riding together to these houses giving this communion. And my grandmother stopped that on a dime, and rightly so. Rightly so. I don't believe in all these church friendships and all of that. Not the way all these pastors running like the wind and everything and all these different people in the church. Absolutely not. So I said, I take my page from my grandmother because she did not play. Mm-hmm. And that's just like how you have to be. You know, call it insecure all you want to, but that's just like, yeah.
No, honestly, like if I meet somebody and they say they have a female best friend, like, I don't know. Like, we always talk about hills we're willing to die on. Like, that's our new saying now. Like, right. Like, you know, with relationships, like, whatever. I'm like, is this the hill I'm willing to die on? I'm like, this would be the hill that this is not something I'm letting go. I would be willing to let the relationship end on this hill. This is the hill I'm dying on. So the female best friend would get a side eye, like a very hard side eye. That would probably be a hill I would have to die on. It's not something I want to be a part of, because I don't believe in that.
Like, all the intimacies, all the female all the best jokes. Friends now. Times that you weren't there in the life, like they're still laughing about things from times when you weren't there, you feeling like alienated, all of that. It's just, no, and women, I'm a woman, so I can speak for us. Okay, I'll take that lead tonight. I just feel like women just kind of sometimes know how to get under each other's skin. Mm-hmm. And so I just feel like they would just be doing like a little extra something, a little extra laughing, a little extra memories. You remember the time? Like, take your hand off. You can remember the time without your hand
without
being on the
touching.
Shoulder.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you remember the time? Oh my God. Do you remember the time? Like, the time when I wasn't there. Okay. Just kind of like emphasize the fact that I wasn't there. And women are very calculating. And men just. What do I call them? Thick of brain.
Thick of brain.
Okay. They
like,
just don't
get
see
it. Yeah.
They just don't see it. They don't see the dirt. They don't get it. They just don't get it. They just don't get it. Okay. And so, it's just like, no, they're not. Oh, they're a doll.
Yeah.
They're always a doll.
Yeah.
I've seen one too many dolls. Okay. When I saw the dirt, I clocked dirt way early on. It's just not like until now when I finally been validated. Okay. For the dirt that I clocked. Okay. And then
sometimes, like, you know, the female best friend can get, like, you know, territorial. Like, you know, now he has a girlfriend.
Yeah.
He's spending time with this girlfriend. It's like, you know, you don't have time for me anymore. You don't have time for your friends. You got this new girl in your life. And it's just, you know, and I wouldn't want a girl, like, talking in his ear like that. Like, you know, like, or him taking our problems to her to get advice. Like, no, absolutely not. I saw somebody say, two people actually asked about, where did it go? What are your thoughts on work wife/husband? Is that emotional cheating? Those are absolutely real.
Yeah.
And I definitely saw it like firsthand when I was student teaching that, you know, most of the people I was working with were married, but the way they interacted with each other, I'm like, this ain't normal. Like, this is definitely like work
really
husband,
thing,
work
right?
wife type thing. Yeah. Making extra copies and making lunch for each other. I'm like, this is odd. Like, there's some flirting going on here. And then they would joke, like, you know, oh, you're my work wife, you're my work husband. I'm like,
Because people spend most of their day at work.
Mm-hmm.
So that to me is like a really true thing. I think, again, there's a fine line there. I don't know. I don't know if that's been my experience really with that, though I know it exists. It wasn't so much my experience with Jay with that, but I saw, like, he really wanted to rise up on the ranks. He really wanted to go far in his career. And I clocked that woman with the twist over heels years ago, and he didn't see what I saw. I felt like I said, because he kept saying she was a millionaire, okay? And I'm like, Jay, people do not become millionaires without doing dirt. She did not get to the top of her profession without having done dirt. So anything that she could possibly be promising you that she could, like, put you in titles and positions, trust me, I don't believe it. I did not believe that woman at all. I thought she was the biggest liar. And he didn't believe me. And ultimately, he got burned for it. And he finally admitted that. But that was, I think, part of the beginning to the end, that because I never worked outside of the house, my word was never taken seriously enough when it came to things like that. That he's like, oh, you don't know. You're not in the business world. You don't understand. I know I understood very well with the wife's eyes. I saw the dirt that was going on, and I just watched, like, I guess at that point from the sidelines, just watching the destruction that I knew was going to happen. But two different companies, so it wasn't like so much the work wife, but just, I don't like anyone having that kind of like long reach, calling into my home for 9 o'clock meetings at night. I was like, not liking it. I think one time we went to a show with you in New York, and on the way down to New York, that smoker voice was in the car, okay? And I'm just like, why do I have to keep hearing that voice? That voice used to just like ping, ping, ping on my nerves. Like, why is she always around? Why is she always around? And Jay is just kind of like that type that doesn't like really get it. So he seriously thought that this was going to get him into the next level where he wanted to be. And I was seeing like a whole nother thing. And just very like she felt like she had like what's that word I'm looking for like oh my God, I'm like, I'm
access or
no, like, access, or... yes, one entitlement. Okay, the sense of entitlement that she was going to provide him with this moving up in the company, and therefore she could call and have all these meetings all the time, these meetings. Okay. And so 8 o'clock at night, 9 o'clock at night, like the business had been shut down. The company's closed at 4 or 5 at night. Everybody lived on the same territory. It wasn't like West Coast, East Coast. Everybody lived here on the East Coast. So I just didn't understand this, and I didn't like it. I felt like in my own home, I have to walk by and see this engagement of these meetings. And it would be on speakerphone, but I just didn't like the fact of this access. And then when it started getting personal, where she would reach out, like if she went on a business trip and now she's back in the area, she would call him and tell him about the business trip. To me, that started getting like, I didn't.
Jay, not just closed, it had been closed.
Yeah, been closed.
It had been closed.
All right, and then you got to call, like, don't you have like your, oh, she had a husband. Don't you have a husband to share these things with? Why don't you pick up the phone and say, I'm back in. I mean, the flight just landed, I'm back. Why would she be calling my husband to tell him that she was back in from a flight? Like I don't go for stuff like that. I definitely am not up for these work wise or even company wise, or I just
the whole, like, yeah, the whole name of it. I think Keish Woodward said it. Where did I see it? She said it like implies that like there's something missing from like the actual wife, that you need a work wife. Yeah. You have the wife at home and then there's like a work wife. Yeah, Kish Woodward, she said, I hate the work wife too. The title alone implies that something is missing from the actual wife. Yeah, like it's just, I mean,
even
the fact that it has a name.
Even in churches, like, I am about as articulate and intelligent and smart than anybody else. And so when we were at church, Jay was promoted to be,
trustee,
okay? Yeah. Again, I had my grandmother's mentality. Why in churches do they have to have a man doing something and then have bringing in another woman? I know how to add money. Okay, I could have sat back in that room. I don't like all of this, everybody sitting around the round table, okay? And my husband's there, and then another woman in the church back there counting money. I know how to count money, but I was never promoted to do that. I think it was just breaking up marriages, because when we first got to the church, it was all of us, the five Wesleys, the husband, the wife, and the three kids, okay? They weren't happy with that. They want to split the marriage up, gave Jay a position, and again, Jay loved titles and positions, took him, moved him to the back, okay, so now he's always back there, got another woman to put her back there so they can count money together. Now, what sense does that make? What sense does that make to me? And I just felt like, I don't get this. So now I'm hearing the word in church, and I'm hearing, but he's not hearing the same thing. So I'm like, did you hear what the minister said today? It could speak to us, it could speak to healing, marriages, family, all of that. He's too busy back there counting money every Sunday, so I'm getting part of the word. He's not getting the word at all. He's back there counting money and just splitting up marriages. I said, this church is running rampant with divorce. And it was, because I think of things like that, where they would just take couples and just break them apart. And I just thought it was destructive. And so that's like where I think I said it in our Truth video. Have we been out here since our Truth video, girl? I don't think we have. Yeah, I said that part I probably still have to heal from right there. That church destruction, that church hurt, that destruction of how I see church now and what they do. They weren't healing or helping at all. If anything, they were part of the problem. Like, we knew each other. I have to ask them about this. I have no problem going up with each other. Yeah, divide and conquer. Exactly. I know, they act like it was a great big title, like it was like keys to the kingdom, okay? I know how to count money, and so why do they have to split us up like that? Why couldn't I go back there? It was like the deacon's lair, I used to call them. Like, oh, God forbid, Laura to be in the deacon's lair. You know, it was like all these titles, everybody jangling the keys and everything. I think sometimes in the black churches, because like the history of them, that people did not have titles, black people didn't have titles, that they would give you a title back then, and I think it just has gone through the years. You get a little bit of a title in the church and can't tell people anything, but I felt like that was extremely destructive in the church that we were going to, that they would split us up like that, knowing that we came in as a beautiful, intact family, and they didn't rest till they plucked him out and put him in the back. What sense did that make?
Mary said, I love Lori. Don't we all?
And then they disguised it as God told them. God told me to do it. So then what can you say at that point? How do you go up against what God says? You doubting God? You know more than God knows? You know, just stupid ignorant talk at that point. You know, I don't know more than God knows, but like you have to like follow, like it has to line up with the word of God. Okay, the Bible says that the husband and wife cleave unto each other. Okay, so now how do they take the scissors and cut the cleavage? All right, and they separated us. So I didn't feel like that was helpful at all. And but you can't question it because I feel like they're very bully-like. They make you doubt like your faith and your Christianity and like you know, well, no, I'm not doubting God. Okay, then I shouldn't hear no more about this out of you. You know, like just bullying kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So then your voice gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, and the rest is history. Okay.
Sabrina Rodriguez said, I never understood why people have or want to keep in contact with their past, their exes. I think it depends on how the relationship ended. Like I'm friends with one of my exes. We dated in high school. But like we'll have conversations like, hey, how's life when we're both single? But like if either one of us go into a relationship, then like the contact like stops. Like because like why would you want to date someone who's still like talking to their ex, even though like it's not like that, and like we'll both like never date again. It was like in high school, and so now we're just like really cool because, you know, whatever. But like when we both get into relationships, it's like deuces.
Exactly.
And that's just like understood between us. Like, it's not even like, you know, oh, you're in a relationship, we're not friends anymore. Like, we get it. Like, if you get somebody, like, you know, we won't have conversations anymore. If I get into a relationship, like, we don't have conversations anymore. Like, that's just that.
Yeah, two shall become one, naturally, Jessica said. Yep, R. Wilson, one of the lead singers, serves every week, and her husband is on the production team. I think it's nice they are together each week behind and in front of the camera. Exactly. If they can have jobs together, I think that's helpful.
What's this, exfoliant?
Yes, I told you that.
I need some chapstick.
I don't have anybody downstairs.
You're sitting here exfoliating your lips?
Uh-huh.
Girl, where's the chapstick properties? And
God told me I should be back there with my husband coming. Right.
I don't have exes. They've all fallen off the planet. Okay.
The Mickey Sampson, I'm going to attempt my first one and done. No gel wash and go with the Curl Chic defining cream. Curl Ooh. Chic, that's the one that we did that time.
Yeah,
right?
She said firm hold. Yep.
Yes, exactly. That hold, I'm telling you, we couldn't pull it, rip it, do nothing.
That hold is serious.
Yeah, it was. We have a video on our channel. Wish me luck. Okay.
What if one person asks you out, but is the one not showing effort and you're the one showing the most? So they ask you out and then they're not showing effort and you're showing effort? Is that the question?
Was there a vibe there when they asked you out? Did the person feel that there was a vibe? That's why they asked. And why are like you doing the most work now when the person initiated it?
Jay, it's probably for the best. Am I the only one who does that? Doesn't acknowledge an ex, whether the ending was good or bad? Nope, gone. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. Next, move on. Good or bad. Right. Have a good life. Either way. Toodaloo. I mean, what else more is there to say? You know?
Okay, so Carmelite Sugar said, simple, they are not serious. As women, we make it so difficult. Do you think it's as cut and dry like as that?
Well, I kind of feel like in this day and age, it has to be cut and dry like that. Like it's, if they're interested, they're going to move like they're interested. And if they're not, then they don't. And it's weird because sometimes like it's like guys will move like they're interested. It's like, oh, like they're interested. Like they'll go kind of hard and then they'll start to fall back. And I don't know why that is or what does that. Cause like it's happened to me a few times. I'm like, mom, like this person was going so hard. And I'm like, now it's like, you know, I don't hear from them. Like, I don't know, like, da, da, da. And like, I could have not done anything, but like just had normal conversations, normal flow of conversations, like whatever. And you think it's heading in one direction. And then like, they like pull back for whatever reason. And like, so yeah, I feel like it kind of has to be like cut and dry to like keep your feelings out of it until you kind of could figure out what's going on. So maybe this person asked you out, you thought, you know, he was about something and maybe he ain't about nothing. Bullet dodged. I don't know.
Yes, like, seriously. I just assume they got distracted by another shiny new object.
Like, testing the waters,
realizing they want to be serious. Yeah, okay. Like, no, like, that's the vibe right now in the dating world. People are just, like, testing the waters. And then realize, like, no, I don't want to be, like, I don't know. It's just, like, they go in and they pull back and they go in and they pull back. Like, it's just.
Games.
Games.
Mm-hmm. They have girlfriends, that's why. What do y'all think about all this Facebook stuff and people friending people and all of these collections of friends? And how serious do you take Facebook stuff?
As far as, like, what? Elaborate a little bit.
As far as your spouses or your significant others and all these friends and all of these female friends and how much you know me and loyalty. Loyalty goes, do you feel like everybody should be friends? Like, if your husband's a friend with someone, do you want to be that a friend with someone? Like, for instance, you know, everybody knows that me and Jay have been separated, and so now we're coming back together, and I saw all of the encouragement, people rooting for us, okay? Even though I've spilled all the tea and all the dirt all year round, okay? But now, like, we're coming back together, and we're trying to make it work. Why would we not? 30 years,
Kim,
okay?
Gregory said, I don't take Facebook serious at all. Why is that?
Who said that?
I feel like all these social medias, your eyebrow needs to be raised just slightly. All of these social medias.
I take it seriously. I don't take it dead seriously, but I think it gets under my skin more than I would like it to, because a lot of things don't get under my skin. But I definitely, I think at times I say, that's where I'm going to, what do we always say?
The hill we're going to die on?
That's the hill I'm going to die on. Yeah, definitely some of these things are the hill that I'm going to die on. So will y'all be dying on these same hills, or you really don't care?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I respect people's relationships. And I was saying to Tay the other day, I've opened up my Facebook page to all of my, to all our followers. I said, but I know that one of the followers' husband reached out and wanted to be a friend. And I said, I don't know that person. Yes, I know the wife. The wife's name is very familiar to me. Why would I want to be a friend with the husband? I wouldn't want it done to me. So I wouldn't do it to anybody else. I don't just collect friends. I don't have anything in common with him. And if he has curly hair on his head or texture, I don't know, because I don't know the person. I interact very much though with the wife. So I don't do that because I wouldn't want it done to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't like that. Like I told Jay and if y'all didn't, like, I don't reach out for my spouse to be a friend. There's not a thing that Jay can tell y'all on Facebook that I can't tell you on videos or Friday. So that's very odd to me that people would do that. I think it's nosy, and I think that like why do it, you know? And so I wouldn't do it. So when I saw that person, I just delete, because I'm like, why would that person want to be my friend? They don't know me. You know, maybe the wife might talk about me a lot and might get a kick out of me, but I wouldn't know. Only the person I reason is because I went and checked to see who the person was and who the wife was. I'm like, oh, okay. But and I'm sure it was harmless. I'm absolutely sure it was harmless, and it wasn't for anything. Just because of the way I think in my mind, I wouldn't do it.
Totally inappropriate.
Who said that?
Oh, I just saw it pop down. Who said it? Markeisha Evans, totally okay. Inappropriate. But I did see before, I liked what, where'd it go? JQ, where'd it go? Oh, Derek Qification said, sometimes men test to see how thirsty you are, like how easy you'll make it for them. Then they realize you're a together woman who's going to take effort. They slink away. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's also the case. They come in just to kind of, again, test the waters to see what kind of woman you are. And if you are a woman that's about something, like, you know, you want a little bit of effort, a little bit of something, you know, and, you know, some guys just aren't willing to go that extra.
Somebody said they agree. I won't befriend my husband's friend. Yeah, because, like, he might have a friend, and he talks about his friend all the time, whatever, and that's nice. But
Jay and Nicole, there's not a thing Bob can tell you that I can't tell you. She said that energy. Girl, so funny.
Really? I know. Y'all see, I get passionate about it. Like, I don't play that game.
No, social media is not something to be taken lightly. Like,
no, it's not.
Really, honestly, to be honest.
Yeah, I really
am. I mean, you don't have to get crazy, like, let me see your phone, let me see your DMs, like, nothing like that. Nothing but, I mean, like, stay woke.
Yeah.
Stay woke.
Yeah. And I am wide awake because of what I went through this last year. And I just, goodness, I wish I could say, let me see the phone, because I'll be deleting folks left, right, and center. All those that I felt like betrayed me, but I know that's way too soon to be doing all that.
All right, we have a new question on the table, which we've definitely spoken on before, but let's speak on it again.
Okay.
How do we feel about seeing taken men liking certain photos on social media?
Wow. You said?
Men that are taken. I mean, I think it's kind of cringe when I see, like, men who I know are married or whatever, like, liking women's pictures. Like, I don't know. I just know personally, like it depends. It depends on me, like the picture. So if a woman is, like, scantily clad, like, bikinis, all that kind of stuff, I don't see why that's necessary. If it's, like, a family photo or something, like, I don't know. Well, it's just, I feel like a like me is meaning you're liking something in the picture. And depending on what the picture is, like, what exactly are you liking about this picture? You're in a relationship. What are you liking?
Yeah, what message is that sending?
Yeah.
That you're liking something. Yeah, I don't, definitely scantily clad. Absolutely not. I don't think that's necessary. Like, what exactly are you liking in that picture? Because that was, like, something that we discussed a few months ago with, that kind of, like, came about with you.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, absolutely not. Like, unacceptable.
Kim Gregor, I don't see anything wrong with it. It's just a picture. Okay, so if the person you were with, like, was liking a picture of a woman in, like, a thong bikini on a beach in the water, like, it's just a picture, there's, like, you don't think there's anything wrong with that? I don't know. I mean, everybody's different. Everyone's, like, relationships are different. There's hills people are willing to die on. That might not be Kim Gregory's hill. But, like,
right. That's
a hill that...
Yeah, no, because to me, it's telling... To me, it's kind of like a form of... I think it's an easy way... And I'm not saying that, like, anybody else's relationship, but I'm saying it's, like, an easy way that a man can get a pass to cheat. You know, back in the day, you know, you can't buy, just because you're on a diet don't mean you can't look at the pastries and all of that. That, you know, that was cute, you know, when you're out, like, with your spouse and, like, they glance over. Men are men and they're going to look at somebody attractive, you know. But now they can do it on or off your watch, okay? Like, you could be out together as a couple and you see somebody and I would get a kick out of it because, like, I would see, like, Jay had a type or whatever. I'm like, oh, I know when you're seeing her, like, and we laugh. Okay, you're together and it's innocent. But now when you're not together 24/7 and men are on social media and they're just liking things, for what? Like, why?
I mean, I would ask the question, I'm like, what? I'm like, I see you like this picture. What about this picture do you like? And then I'm gonna wait for an answer. Like, what do you like about this? This woman is standing here, not dressed. Like, what are you liking? And to me, it's disrespectful.
Yeah, women and men alike both are thirsty, but, you know, you like a woman's picture, and if she's single, like, why, as a married man, you would like a single woman's picture like that? You know, I think it's disrespectful to your wife. I really do. So I think it's extremely disrespectful.
I'm going to say, we know what that fool likes. Exactly, but I just want to hear them say it. Like, say it. Like, what are you like? Like, it's just disrespectful. Like, I don't know.
You can like, but not publicly.
And it's like, if you're scrolling and, like, you're appreciating some, like, I'll never know that. Like, if you're on social media and you see a woman, like, but, like, to actually boldly, like, attach your sign and name, your Facebook name, your Instagram name, your Twitter name, your whatever name to this picture. Now you are one of the people under the likes. Like, why do that? Why are you making that kind of statement?
Even Ray Charles cheated.
Yeah, see, that's to be expected, just not publicly. Like, exactly. So.
Yeah, to me, celebrities, to me, aren't innocent enough. Like, to me, that's, like, a whole nother thing. Like, a celebrity, you know, if we say, like, Idris Elba?
But see,
I'm never going to run away.
What's Idris a celebrity Elba? In 2019 with all these influencers and Instagram models? And that might just be for, like, people my age. Like,
what's
a celebrity? Somebody who has, like, 500K, and again, bikini photos, thong pic, like, I mean, what's a celebrity? Girly Angel. Nah, I'm not okay with my husband liking any woman's photo. I don't care if she has a nun outfit on. Not having it. Because, I mean, it's just not necessary. bottom line, like, it's just, why is it necessary? I just want to know why it's necessary. If someone could explain to me why it's necessary, those people who don't care, like, why is it necessary? Yeah.
You guys are funny.
Yeah, I just think it's disrespectful and it's not necessary at all. Like,
I don't know.
What happened to the day when there was no Facebook? You know, why do they have to make that statement? Why do they have to go out there like something? Like you said, if it's a cute little birthday party for their child or something, okay.
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to see like I'm like some controlling person who's like insecure and like crazy checking people's phones, like, I don't want you doing this, I don't want you doing that. Like, there's just certain things that I just feel I like and things I don't like, things I think are necessary and things
to
that,
me, I
that
think
aren't
there's
necessary.
Things that are common sense.
Yeah,
I mean, I think things are just common sense that, like, you really don't have to like tick off the list, like, you could do this but you can't do that. You could, I think, out of the respect for the relationship, like, go back to old school before all of this social media, you know, would your husband be on the phone calling somebody else just to say, hey, how's it going? Like, I mean, you know, it just wasn't like that. When I go back to my grandmother's time, and it just wasn't that kind of freedom and familiarity as it should be in a marriage on both sides. I think it's very disrespectful, and you're inviting problems into the situation. So I don't think there's room.
So we have the same question on the table right now, or out on the floor. Two people asked it. Would you ever have a joint social media account? And then how do you all feel about couple Facebook pages? I don't think it's something I'd ever do. Mm-hmm. I don't mind having separate Facebook pages or whatever. But to have,
yeah, I don't know. No, I'm not, I wouldn't go that far.
Because, like, we all have, like, we would have our own voice. Like, I have my own friends, my own family has friends that, like, we have our own voice, things we like to post. Like,
absolutely.
I wouldn't want a joint Facebook account.
Not at all. No, I wouldn't want to do that at all. I like my own pictures. I like my own profile picture. I like, not yet. Like you said, each page has their own voice. I like certain pictures and do different things. So no, I don't think that's necessary. I just think that there's this protocol. I think that people should know how to conduct themselves. And if they don't, then they probably don't need to be on Facebook and have a Facebook page.
Mm-hmm.
If it means that much to them to want to disrespect their spouse in that.
I just feel like it's more attractive when a man's not thirsty. Like, you don't need to be one of the, like, you know, whatever, even, I don't care how many people are under the picture that are just like liking this woman's picture who's not giving you no attention. She's not bothered with you. Like, why do you gotta be thirsty? Like, you know, you don't need to be one of those people under the picture. Like, don't let it be my man being thirsty under somebody else's picture, giving likes, and she's not paying you no mind. Like, stop.
That's what I feel. Where's that at? LaToya, that Malachi said, the man is the one who has to respect the relationship and not like the inappropriate pictures. I always felt that way. And so, like, take it back to my time where I felt I never understood if you're in the relationship with a person and then he starts cheating that you're going to go and beat up the person he's cheating with.
I wish I would.
I said I would. No, I said, like, it's not that person's fault. Yeah. It's not the woman's fault. It's like you are in the relationship with that guy. If that guy goes off, I'm not going to beat up the woman.
Fight
that,
the woman.
That makes no sense.
People are like, I'm going to fight her and him. Like, why? She don't got no loyalty to you.
Nope.
Like,
it has nothing. She get a pass. Has nothing to do with her. It has to do with the person.
Dougie, what are you doing?
It has to do with the person in the relationship. So no, you guys are the ones that had the vows, okay? Not that person over there. So that person has nothing to do with it.
But yeah, the whole liking like pictures thing, like, that's totally like up to the couple. So I just saw like Micah Tyler say, I don't care about liking pics, maybe because I like pics too, LOL. If he's communicating with the person, then I would be mad. So, like, yeah. So, like, the liking picture thing might not be, like, a thing for, like, certain couples. Like, she might be liking pictures, he might be liking pictures. Like, it's like, we don't care, like, about that. But I know, personally, it's not something, like, I personally like, you know.
Do like, what do likes mean to you guys? What do, because, like, we were, like, discovering and unraveling, unpacking how you let's unpack what these likes mean. Sorry, I'm distracted. I'm constantly looking at what the doggy's doing. What's he doing? I don't know. He's doing. All right, what does that mean? What message is that sending? Likes or likes thereof, or they call them stalkers. You know darn well people are on your page. You know darn well people are on your page. However, they can't seem to like push that like button and support anything that you're doing. And so what do you guys feel about that liking or lack thereof of liking?
Liking means you like it, right?
And what happens when you don't like something that somebody's doing? I mean, I'm not saying like people have lives, okay? Nobody's on there 24/7.
Yeah.
However, let's just share, okay, what we felt through Thanksgiving. Okay, everybody knows, like I said a couple of minutes ago, me and Jay had, well, let me see, I'll take the blame for that. I made it very public about us breaking up. Everybody knows he's in Colorado. Everybody knows I'm here in Connecticut, and we're working through that now. However, we did start noticing, me and you, the lack of the like in the support. Mackerel's fam, y'all all supported, okay? Everybody was happy, okay? Y'all blew it up, okay? However, it's people that were closest to us. As we said last year when we were going through our trials and tribulations, there was no help to be found. The people that we noticed that were closest to us, their hand can't seem to find that like and love button. And like it's like almost like they basically had buried us and thrown the dirt over in the grave. Like people love dissension, love breakups, they love that kind of thing. And when you see people trying to work it out, as like I said, why would we not? That's 30 years, why would we not? And so, but I don't see that much support in that area now. Again, Mackerel's fam, yes. People closest to us, no, and I'm shocked. I would think that they would be so happy that, you know, like we're working through it now, and you just don't see now. How much stock do you put into that? You know, it's just, it's telling. All I can say is it's telling, not like it really matters one way or another. But it's just very, as our drama channel, it's very interesting, they always say. It's very interesting. Yeah. They don't know what else to say. It's very interesting.
Very interesting.
Yeah. Misery loves company, right?
You're liking the supportive poll.
I started caring way too much about likes. Yes, I said that to you the other day. I said it can get under your skin after a while.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Right, you gotta stay not bothered.
Hurt people, I see other people hurting. Lorraine, be careful. These people usually have a hefty opinion on your situation and voice their emotions probably too much. That was a conversation that we shared. I said, I always talk about my faults to my own detriment. I said, I definitely took my blame in that. I mean, for goodness sake, I put my whole life out on social media. So I said, I have no one to blame for people knowing our situation. So for people that have strong opinions on both sides, I said, I cannot only just take the blame myself that I put my business out there. I said, you have had to have shared enough of our situation with people to have such strong opinions about you getting back with your wife of 30 years. Like people like are like shying away from like liking that or giving strong opinions about that. I think it's like, okay, yes, granted, we put our business out there. And so now we're putting it back out there. We're saying we're working on things now. So all people, if we like it, then they should love it. Okay, then they should love it. And so for people that to support that, I said, what did you possibly say? I know what I said. Okay, y'all know what I said. However, I'm reeling it back in now. So now everybody's going to go this way with me, okay? See, I was going that way last year. Okay.
And it was too late.
There was no mending it, okay? And now I'm swinging back this way because why? I want to mend it, all right? And so anybody that's not, like, on the boat, like, why? Why do you care that much? Why are you that invested in a couple breaking up that much? Why are you that invested? And people are seriously bothered. People are seriously bothered by it. And I just want to ask one question. Why? What does me and Jay getting back together have to do with you?
Apparently Mad Dad's in the house.
Is he? Hey, Mad Dad.
I scrolled up and I saw Doggy's face. Yep, there he is.
Okay. Yep. And so what does it have to do with anybody other than the mad dog and mad man's face there? You know, what does it have to do with anybody other than us? And so that, to me, is very problematic, very disturbing. And I call it planting seeds. Planting seeds, just one word that's going astray. One thing that someone gives a strong opinion. You know, when things are so delicate and they're so new, why would somebody not encourage it? Why would somebody have a strong opinion to make a person think, you sure you want to get back? You sure you want to get back? You sure you want to remember when he did? I remember every single thing because I'm the one that told y'all for y'all to remind me right now to remember it. So why do I need to be reminded of things that happened a year ago? We're two adults. We're in a relationship. We know exactly what we're so-called getting ourselves back into. Why does anybody else care? Mm-hmm. We don't care.
Michelle Darkenel, so he who finds a wife finds a good thing. I swear I've been telling myself that for the past couple of months. I'm still waiting on my big nose husband. I'm like, he who finds a wife, that means he's supposed to find me. So I'm supposed to sit here patiently. I tell myself, I'm like, he who finds a wife, he who finds a wife. So let me just wait patiently.
Hi, honey. I see Jay right there.
I see doggy
space. Are you coming to guard me? You know, this is, what do they call this? This is a safe space.
This is a safe space.
I say what I want to say.
Say what you said.
They come here to hear the truth here.
That's true. As Jolie, she said, you should always be wanting reconciliation. People forgive people in their own lives. You can't receive forgiveness without giving it. That goes for all relationships. It's very true.
Mm-hmm. I find it so strange that and it happens, and I said to you today, I said any time from 25 years on to me is a really big struggle. I think like the first year, they said the 7-year rich, there's certain years that are key that are known for like the struggle. I never knew about the 25-year struggle, but I realized when I hit 25 years and it seemed like things struggled there. I think,
Ari Brown, no, girl. Huh? Girl, that's all you, sis. She said change your status to Mary Tay. Speak it into existence.
Oh, she did that right.
Yeah, won't people think I'm married? I remember people were saying for me to stop wearing my rings on my ring finger because I wore, like, this big gold ring on my ring finger. Like, people are going to think you're married.
But we were saying today, that's a lot of time. And I've seen a lot of people walk away and then remarry. You know, like seriously, they really walk away from 25 to 30 years like that. 25, but that is a lot of time. And they will walk away from that amount of time. I mean, that is memories. That is having children. That is sicknesses. That's illness. I mean, that is your kids going through school, going through college. You can be grandparents. How do people walk away from 25 to 30 years?
Yeah.
I mean, I talked a tough game. I had no other choice. I had to. What was I going to do? Things were that bad for us. So I just gird myself, just do what I have to do. Again, I think there was something on Facebook the other day that said I have my grandmother in me, so I'm a very strong person, and so I just do what I have to do. But it really, really took its toll on me. I just never pictured being in my 50s and not being in my marriage. I just never pictured it, but it was the cards that were dealt to me, and so I dealt with it the best way I could throughout the year, and I took the lessons that were there, that, you know, presented themselves, so I learned more, I grew from it. However, when this new opportunity came about for reconciliation, absolutely, I was all in. Absolutely all in, because that's how I always pictured it. You know, our circumstances were so, we felt insurmountable at the time. There was like illness on top of illness, you know, job losses, empty nest. I mean, there were so many things that a marriage that could survive that was just, you know, had to be stellar. It was just a lot. You know, with no support from anyone at any corner. And so we did the best that we could. But to not, like, try to make it work, that I'm glad that, you know, we got a chance to make this work. Yeah, I know. Thank you. Who's it? Kimi. I know. I always say my message will one day be my message. I say I want to provide to people that was not provided to me, you know, that kind of support. That it really is true. It does get bumpy, the ride, as you go through, and you don't throw in the towel. You know, when you think of, again, my grandmother and that generation, they didn't throw in the towel.
The generation was just different.
Yeah, they worked at everything. They didn't care what the issues were. They worked through things.
I was speaking to someone today who lost his grandfather, and he said that his grandmother's still alive, and they were together for 68 years, and I was like,
like, is that even heard of these days? Like 68 years? And if it is, mm-hmm. it's because it's that generation, like back there, you know, I'm wondering like what our generation is going to look like and how long like marriages are going to stay together. People who are getting married now, millennials, that kind of thing, because like the journey, like for almost like 70 years, like, and they stayed together. I was just like, wow. And then I would just be so heartbroken to be with someone for that long. Mm-hmm. And then, I mean, we all are going to pass one day, but to be with someone basically your whole life and then they pass, like, that's horrible. Like, oh,
yeah,
you know, that's such a long time.
That's a very, very long time.
That's such a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, everything, I think in one of our videos, and you, there were the comments underneath, I'm like, Taylor, let Lorianne be happy. I'm like, can I be happy this year? I said, last year I was absolutely miserable. I'm like, can I just at least be happy this year when we go out and I go shopping and I'm buying all the things to decorate? I'm like, can I please just be happy? Just let me enjoy, because I'm like so different mentally this year than
I was. She means let her spend her coins in peace.
Like, let her spend herself in the poorhouse.
No judgment zone.
Like, no judgment zone.
Let me just decorate my house. It just looks like a winter wonderland for Halloween. It's just like an explosion of Halloween. You know, for Thanksgiving, you know, I decorated gift and blessings and thanks everywhere, turkeys everywhere. You know, so now Christmas is just an explosion of Christmas, or it's soon to be, because everything's on the table, just hasn't been laid around. Mm. But you know, I'm in a happy place this year, and it was a long time coming. It was a long year. It was a long year. A long year.
Somehow I saw someone say the other day, they felt like 2019 was like 2 years. There's like two different sections of 2019. I feel like there was like the January to like maybe the July section, mm-hmm. and then like the July to like December, like this section over here. It feels like two different years.
Thank you, Lisa. Marriage don't exist anymore. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. Are millennials getting married? Do people want to be married?
I don't know. I just know it's a lot of work, and I do know. And I'm glad, you know, I'm glad God saved me from myself, you know, and I'm glad that we were poor. I'm glad that nobody could afford a divorce, because I probably would have done something impulsive. Okay, but when I started, like, checking out those attorneys. Seriously, no, because when I started hearing them retaining fees and all that, I was just like, okay, well, maybe I'll just put this on hold for a while. Other things came first. Other things I had to prioritize, like food on the table and, you know, propane in the tank. All right, so that was just like, okay, that'll be there, you know, when I want that. But when people have money, like the celebrities in Hollywood and stuff, they just go right out, married one day, divorced the next. No problem.
Yep.
I mean, I'm glad that I didn't have that kind of ready finances, because I probably impulsively, you know, because of the anger and the madness at the time, absolutely I would have done it. Absolutely I would have done that. And probably would have regretted it. And then it would just be like silly now, like we'd be getting along and then just like just hanging out. But who
so would you like have to have another wedding?
Girl, see, that's what I'm saying. Acting like I'd have to be like silly like that now. Like, yeah, see, I'm like doing all of that now. So I'm glad that we just like status quo. Like everybody kind of like just went to their corners and we all kind of like sorted out our lives at that point.
Micah, and, Tyler, how do you feel about that? She what? Said, all my friends are married and I'm 32. Most of them seem in positive relationships. I feel like a lot of the people I know are either engaged, married, or had a kid kind of already. And I'm just like, even though I'm only 26, but like, I don't know. Like she said, she's 32 and like most of her friends are married.
It,
and
is it because you've been selective over the years? Have you put your job first? Did you not date a lot?
She said, I'm happy for them. The ones that are not happy remind me not to rush. I'm 36 and most of my friends are married too.
Okay, we're Gen X, right? I'm Gen X.
Girl, I never remember.
I think I'm Gen X. I saw something the other day that was about a show made for Gen X. And I said, I think I'm Gen X. But anyway, still, I was thinking what your father was saying. So I'm Gen X and I'm going out 16 years married together for 19. Okay. Yeah, I mean, that's still a lot of time.
You know,
Huggins says lots of millennials aren't getting married or having children. It's so expensive. I was reading something about that the other day, but it was more along the lines of millennials, like depression and anxiety and something they called it. I always thought it was the depths of despair, but they were calling it the deaths of despair. Have we been saying it wrong?
No, I think it's the depths.
Okay, they were calling it deep. Like that's what I thought, but they were calling it the deaths of despair. But basically, they were saying that like our generation, which we talked about before, like millennials, like they're more prone to like anxiety and depression. It's because stuff is so expensive. People aren't in relationships or getting married or having kids. People can't afford it, and it's just like we're more like stressed out and just depressed. And
so, aren't millennials considered the forever young generation? I thought baby boomers were considered forever young. Are millennials considered that? I don't know if they're considered that as much as I felt that they were treated as such. And I only can remember that when you guys went into college, was it you or Spencer, where I went into the auditorium, they were talking to the parents, and they said that an 18-year-old then was considered to be like a 15-year-old immaturity because these were the kids that were just pampered and given everything and spoiled. And so now these kids, these millennials now that we've raised, have been given everything with very little expectation, very little, demands on them, just given things, not asked too much of them. And so now they have this sense of entitlement. They just march through the world with a sense of entitlement. Some have it worse than others in this household, but you do kind of see it a little bit. You know, you do kind of see it, and you have to check it every now and then. But I don't know if they're considered forever young. They just were treated, I think, forever young.
I just feel like, I don't know, like they say like women have like time clocks. Like men can have kids like any point, but like women I feel like have... I feel like, isn't it true, like, women have, like time clocks, even though Janet Jackson didn't have a time clock. Like, didn't she have a baby at, like, 60?
Oh,
like,
girl, she was 50.
Oh, 50. Okay. I don't know. It was just always my thing. Like, I wanted to have kids before, like, at least start having kids before I was 30. And I'm just like, you know, what if that doesn't happen? Like, I mean, it's not up to me, I guess. Like,
oh, thanks. Like, Kish Woodward said,
God kind of already knows how my life is going to go. I just kind of have to wait and see how it unfolds. But it would be, you know, my wish to kind of at least have one under my belt before I'm 30. At least one, like, you know, to get started, get married. My thing was I always wanted to get married, like, be able to enjoy my husband for a couple years, and then we start having kids. Like, that's the plan.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, as I start getting older, it's like tick, 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 tick. And so, I don't know. That's just what I think about.
Who else is looking at the ticking of the time? Single, no kids, 36. When do they ever want to go down that aisle?
They don't.
Mm-hmm.
You always talk about that aisle.
I do talk about that aisle. I know
that aisle.
Yeah, thank you, Kish. That's a compliment. She said, thanks, Jay, your film is inspiring. I know we didn't plan on them being the inspiration. We've heard that a lot now. I'm glad, like, what we went through has inspired a lot of people. And
good night, Aaliyah.
You know, I think years ago I was watching T.D. Jakes on TV, and he said something that was very prophetic at the time. Little did I know, but he said that God is going to put your life on stage. He's going to put you out there, you know, for His glory. Like, and at the time I didn't understand it, and I saw that message and I received it at the time. Little did I know how God would really put my life out there on stage, you know, and whether, you know, I put my own stuff out there or not, you know, it was definitely out there. And I don't regret that because, you know, we're real people, I say, with real problems. Unique probably to me is that I put it out there. But, you know, we're on social media. It's like what we do. We're mad girls, you know. And so my life, I had to share. You know, we couldn't hide it. We explained in videos that some videos we looked sadder than other videos. And, you know, we couldn't hide it any longer. So that was the original R-Truth video where we finally had to share what we were going through. And I'm just a person that just really kind of like wears her emotions on her sleeve. And so there was just like so much hiding I can do. I just am a very transparent person. And if I can't be that way, I'm uncomfortable. I never like to go any place and be anonymous. I hate that anonymity where people say, can we have your opinions and you don't have to sign your name. I want to sign my name. I want people to know how I feel, right, wrong, or indifferent.
I like exposing. I like to talk, and I take responsibility for. I take responsibility for everything. People always say.
Yeah. Okay. I take full responsibility.
I take full responsibility.
Like, who else is gonna take responsibility?
Yeah. I hate going under that cloak of anonymity. I don't want to be anonymous. I like people to know that it's me who said I'd like to sign my name. So I probably wouldn't have known how to navigate it any other way last year, other than just feeling like this was a place where I could just come and just share. No, still trying to hide. And because I wouldn't be myself, you know, I would be off for months if even we could have even been successful, because I could not have gone on camera and pretended for so much longer. Mm-hmm. You know, I had to probably just share that. And then it just made it so much easier.
Mm-hmm. The Kevy Project, I like what you said. She said, don't put a timer on God's clock. And she said she had her first at 35. So, yeah, mm-hmm. Anything can happen at any time. It's just, I don't know. When I was in high school, I was always like, yeah, I'm gonna be married with a kid by 25. And then, I don't know, I think a lot of people like say like crazy stuff like that when they're in high school. And then it just like doesn't happen because you can't really plan your life out like that.
Right. I know, Veronica, the kids do keep you young. I know. You know, that's why people can't like look inside of anybody's homes, because all of my adult children, full-fledged adults, Spencer's 27, you're 26, and Adam is 20, and they all live under this roof, and I could not be happier, you know. And it is nobody's business, not one person's business out there, to have opinions about that too. Again, everybody, because we put our life out there, okay? So but it's nobody's business. Like, they don't know the dynamics of our family. You know, when Jay went to Colorado, I was here by myself. Everybody knows I have multiple sclerosis. What in the world could I have done? You guys know I never paid a bill. I never lived on my own. I never did any of that stuff. So now for everybody to be out on their own, successful in college careers and all that, you know, that's great. But what does success really look like? Success to me looks like a family supporting like their family. Okay. And at the same time, you still were able to do all that you had to do, like in your time frame when you were ready. And so look at how God opens up that door right now.
Which is something like we've been recently talking about. I was like, because I am subbing in a school district that I went to, so people know me, so they're asking like, you know, the what are you doing now question. It's like, I'm 26, and it's like, I hate the question. I really hate the question, because I feel like I'm not doing enough to like I'm not where I should be, kind of thing. But like, people don't know like what I've gone through like the past couple of years, and it's just too much to go through, like a whole like life story, like, you know. And it's just like, I hate the question. Like, I cringe, like, you know, well, I went to school. And now, like, you know, like, oh, so you're a teacher. So then it's just, I don't know. I just, the question, I hate the question. Like, so what are you doing now? And, you know.
Spencer said that too, even though he's not as like forthcoming as you are with it, like maybe it bothered him or whatever. But at the same time, you were asked it, he was asked it, you know. People say, I think they asked him, was he doing for the holidays? Was he going out to other people's homes, or were people coming into his home? And he said, like, what do I say? He said, where my holiday dinner is where, like, I live at, like, in my mom's house or parents' house, whatever, you know. And so you both had that. And how Jay said it is that when Jay went to Colorado, I didn't know any other way to do it. I split, like, we were college roommates. I split this thing three ways. Like, we pay everything equally, okay? It's not like I'm the mother and like I hand them one bill, or, you know, you like, no, we split this three ways, and these kids pay substantially for us to live here. It's Fairfield County in Connecticut. I couldn't do it on my own. So no, we split it three ways. So Jay said, the way I see it is that they like,
yeah, because I was asked,
could
like,
be living with anyone. Like, I could be living with my kids. My kids could be living with me. Like, this is done three ways. All of our name is on the lease. Equally, we all, because
it's an expensive, culpable. It's an expensive town. So they were like, you know, do you live in the town? And I was like, yeah. They're like, oh, so like, you know, so you're married or whatever. And I was like, you know, no. I was like, you know, I live at home. And you were kind of like, stop saying that. Like, it's all like, we all kind of like rent the place. It's not really like you live in your parents' house. Like, you pay to live here. Your name's on the lease. Like, this is your house just as much as it's my house. So it's not like you're living
at the time
with your parents, like in that way. Kind of thing. But it was just like, oh, like, she assumed I was married, and I was just like, no, like, I live at home. And she was just kind of like you're 26, like, you're living at home, like.
But in all actuality, you're really not, because when Jay moved to Colorado, we reorganized everything, and so all new leases, all of that, and now who's on it, it's all three of us on that. Even Adam, but Adam not paying anything yet because he's still in college.
He gets a pass.
He gets a pass. I'm just waiting for the day, okay? But no, on a serious note, it was reworked, redone. It wasn't like Jay and Lori anymore on the lease. Now it was like all of us on it. Me, Spencer, and Taylor all on it, all three names. So either all of us could actually be living with all of us, okay? Granted, it started out as you living in your parents' home, but it changed last year, and now all three of us are equally as responsible on that. So technically, it is kind of like having like your own place.
And then it's like I graduated college in like 2016, and it's just like, so what have you been doing all this time? Kind of like look on their face, like, you know, why are you just being a substitute teacher? Like, you know, you're a whole certified teacher. Why is this what you're doing? Like, and it's like, why do I have to break down the past 2-3 years of my life and why I am like where I am? So I'm just like, when people are like, hi, so what are you doing now? And it's just like, and then the look on their face when it's just like that, basically, like, that's all you're doing. And it's just like, I'm like, mom, like, they don't know the story.
And it is very societal. I think Caramelized Sugar said it's like, you know, you go to college, you get married, you have a baby. It's just like boom, boom, boom. And so that, I think that's where the pressure is now, because your generation are doing things slightly different, and you're looking at your parents who did things different from you, and you're like, okay, you got married at a certain age, you had kids at a certain age, like, why is this not happening to me? But things are just really different now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, things are just so different now.
And it's just like, I haven't shared that I'm a YouTuber. Like, nobody knows that. Like, I figured I'd cross that bridge if it ever came up, and I don't feel like it's gonna come up, because like the district I'm in, there aren't really a lot of like ethnic people with natural hair. I'm like, I don't feel like Mad Curls will be discovered. So it's not something I feel comfortable sharing right now, because I don't know if it will affect my job. And I enjoy teaching, I enjoy what I do. I don't know how much social media teachers can have. I don't know if they'd want me to shut down my Instagram, shut down my YouTube, because that's like that's like the income. That's like the most significant part of my income is Mad Curls, and then substitute teaching like supplements that. So I would not give up Mad Curls to do this, because like it's, you know, which I don't know why they would want me to, because I would like have to sit down and explain. It's just hair. We just sit down and we talk about hair products. Like, that's all it is. It's nothing more than that. It's nothing inappropriate. There's no cursing. There's no, you know, inappropriate topics. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a family channel basically, because I do it with my mom. So why I would have to shut down my YouTube channel? Why can't I have both? But
even when we're freer to talk on, I was gonna say Friday nights, it's Thursday now, but it might go back, because this y'all, is Thursday working for you? Because we're like thinking it's not working for us.
I don't know. It's been a full house kind of for us in here tonight. Okay. Almost 300 people at one point.
Why
are those of you in the dark, not in the comments? Hi, right. Thanks for watching.
Why is living at home so frowned upon? But I think that we're very careful what we say. I don't think there's anything. Yes, I have strong opinions, whatever, but I don't think it's inappropriate. I don't think there's any cursing.
Yeah.
Anything scandalous that we could say that they could call you on, even in our freedom of speaking.
I just know how, like, just being, at least like in the high school setting, that's basically where I am.
Oh yeah, the house, that would
how
be a distraction.
They are about, yeah, it would be. How they are about social media, like they're obsessed with Instagram, they're obsessed with TikTok, like all those kinds of things. And to find out that their teacher who's in the room is, you know, has a YouTube channel that's like successful, like, I mean, that would totally be a distraction. I don't know if they would be like, yeah, no, you can't be doing this. And so like, I keep it quiet. Like, I haven't told anybody that I do YouTube or any of that.
Yeah. And like I said, that's like your choice, because I didn't really see, but I can see where you're coming from with it, only because of the people that you work with. I think that they could handle it, but I think the kids.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the kids couldn't handle it. They would love it. Yeah.
Oh, thanks, honeycomb. I know there was one teacher was like, oh, we should put you in like the town paper, how we have a local celebrity, this. And then I'm like, no. None of that. No town paper.
I know, like,
no,
it's
no,
when we went to
no.
Spencer's thing, and you're like, Ma, don't say anything, I keep a low profile. Next thing you know, you saw my legs crossed and I was holding the conversation. You're like, there she goes, off and running.
Yeah. See, Cam C said, don't tell them nothing. Nothing wrong with something. Stay in your business. Exactly.
Okay.
Like,
okay.
To me, I just feel like, that's Mad Curls is mine. Like, it's my,
yeah.
Like, it's nothing that needs to be shared at this point.
Okay.
Right now, I just, you know, I just don't. And especially since
the older generation doesn't really understand YouTube kind of to begin with. So it's just like, you do what? You're what? Like, and being young, being 26, like, I'm already kind of just like the youngest person subbing in the crowd anyway. And now it's like, oh, she's a YouTuber. Like, it's just,
yeah,
she's immature. She's like, I don't know how they would take it. So I would just rather not. I'm still trying to make a name for myself to be taken seriously, because I still feel like I kind of get side-eyed when people see me, like, you know, is she a student? I still get that. Where's your pass in the hallway? Like, I'm a whole teacher. I don't need a pass. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, so.
Okay, so I'm reading the comments, so I like this. So people are saying that there's success. Latrice Hubbard, I like that. I think people should just mind their own business in household. No opinions or unsolicited advice needed. That's what I think. I said, I wouldn't have the nerve to give strong opinions like that. I just don't have it in me, believe it or not. I just don't. When people present things to me, I just don't. If they're happy with it, like, who am I to, like, throw in that kind of doubt? So I would not do that. But no, you'd be surprised how many people have strong opinions. And I say, we have nobody to blame but ourselves, you know, for all the times that we shared that. And I'm not talking about, like, you guys, because we see you guys in a very small window. I'm talking about people that we deal with on a daily basis. People we deal with on a daily basis that have more access to give those opinions. I just don't like hearing those opinions like that. Because to me, this is hard enough trying to mend. And when you have people kind of like throwing in those seeds of doubt, like, are you sure? Remember when she did that? Remember when he did that? You know, I don't want to hear that. Like, I'm done, so then you should be even dunner. Mm-hmm. Okay, with that. I don't want to hear that. Like it's a new beginning. And so I think that that's hard. So I don't feel like Latrice said people should be giving.
Aaliyah Huggins said, Tay, what would you do if your students found out about your channel on their own? I would own up to it.
Mm-hmm.
If they asked, they said, like, you know, is this you? Like, yep.
Yeah.
That's my channel. That's Mad Girls. Like, but I'm not bringing it to the forefront. Like, I had a girl. It was actually middle school. I think she was an eighth grader. She was sitting in the back of the class trying to vlog. She had the vlog camera and the tripod. And I'm like, you know, we're not doing that. Like, in here, she's like, I have a YouTube channel. I'm like, well, vlog during lunchtime or something. Like,
what did somebody say? Yeah, she has, like, what, like, they said 700 followers.
She has, like, 700 followers or something. And I'm like, okay. I'm like, well, shout out to your YouTube channel. I'm like, but this ain't the time for that. I get the gig, though. Right. But, like, it wasn't the time for me to say, well, I have a YouTube channel. She's like, I'm not sharing that information. But if it was ever found, like, I would own up to it. Like, yeah. That's my channel. And I just saw someone say, I think it was Andrea Twitty, she said, you know, teachers have second jobs. Yeah, they do. That's another thing that I would say, like, that is my other job. I mean, teachers teach. The summer times, they're doing other stuff. I mean, there's tons of teachers who have different jobs. So mine just happens to be a YouTube channel where I talk about hair products and life, and I do it with my mom. Like, I did shut down the bathing suit collab, though. That video got put on private. That one had to go. Just in case. Bathing suit lookbook.
Looking crazy, guys, because there's a serious breeze coming here, a draft. Oh, my gosh. Like, all my propane is going out. This house is so freezing cold, and there's just drafts everywhere.
I know. Oh, my God. It's 10 o'clock. Tomorrow, folks got to work. That's one good idea. I was like, yeah, no, that needs to get shut down right now.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. But they're not letting you shut it down too much. They keep saying, do you have any friends that could do that? They said, could you just, like, hold them up in pictures? Like,
yeah, no, the company still wants more, like, class. I'm like, no. I'm like, I cannot. No.
Yeah.
Can't do that. Cannot do that. At this point in time.
Let's see. Mary Ellen has a PhD, she said. Why wouldn't Markeisha say to her? He just said he'd be in a good boy. You are so cute. You are so
bring him
cute.
Over because we should start wrapping. Probably by 10.
It's doggy time.
We'll bring. Oh my God, my foot's asleep. Oh my God, my foot's asleep. Okay, bring Doug.
Yeah, whatever you guys are doing, like, thank you so much, because after our truth update, whatever, what's he doing?
He's just sitting. He's so cute.
I think we said in there that the only way that people could support us this year is just, like, just watching our videos. And I'm telling you guys, the videos are being watched. We think people are watching them in their entirety. Switch has been flipped or something. But we think that you guys are watching them in their entirety because we're noticing that.
Here's Doggy.
There he is. Look at Doggy.
Okay. He's more excited to see you than he is to see
me. Doggy, are you excited to see me? Okay, doggy. Thank you, baby. All right, turn around and face the crowd. All right, doggy, lots of kisses for what?
My sweatshirt says Beav. I think it's Beav or it's Bev, I think. If you guys watched Survivor season 30, the one where Wendell Holland won, 36, I think. I don't know. He has a company.
What are you doing?
Where he like makes furniture. This is his furniture company.
Oh, I see. He's going crazy. Guys, he loves tissues. He sees a tissue down here. Nope. Goodbye. There. It's gone.
No tissue.
No tissue. No tissue for you. Now face the crowd. Say hi. And say you're doing your best to be a good boy. Who saw him in the snow?
He is so big now. Oh my gosh. Yeah. If you're not friends with us on Facebook, oh my gosh. The pictures. He's so naughty. He loves the snow.
Lots of kisses. Lots of kisses. Buggy. Dougie, guys, did you see his boots? His crazy. He had him so dressed. He had a parka on. He had snow boots.
Now he goes out there like that. He didn't want any of that. He didn't want his pajamas. He didn't want his little thermal things on. He didn't want his coat, his parka.
The first day you had a hat, coat, boots, everything. Guys,
and he
was
it off one by one.
Bothered. Yeah, now he just goes out like this. And rolls around in
rolls
the snow.
Rolls on his back. Rolls all in the snow. I tell him, like, Doug, am I going to go outside? We're going to use the facilities. We're going to pee. We're going to poo. Am I going to come back inside? That's what's going to happen. Yeah. And we go outside, and he's rolling in the snow. And now he's eating it. He's eating it like ice because, like, now the snow is getting hard. And so I hear him outside crunching.
Yeah.
And he's just eating the snow.
Yeah.
I know. He is getting so big so fast.
He's getting so big, my dugginess. Yeah, tonight was fun, guys. I really enjoyed tonight. First I came here,
this
like,
was
I was just so tired. Me and you were, like basically egging each other on upstairs. I'm like, I'm so tired. I'm only going to be on there for 5 minutes. I'm just going to stop by, like, you know, in that show, To Catch a Predator. Guys, I just came by to tell you, guys, we can't do this tonight.
Yeah.
We had, like, all of these things. He's like, I don't even think we're going to be on for an hour. I'm like, oh, no, definitely not an hour. Oh, no, none of that. And it's been fun, right?
Yeah, it's 7, 8, 9. We're going on 3 hours.
Are we?
We're going on 3 hours.
They want us 7.
Yeah.
Wow.
Not yet. Oh, y'all.
Yeah. Wow. So very good. So who's new? I always like to know who's new in the room.
Who's
new
in the house?
Some names look tame. But it's Kish. Is that no one? Kish, what that name? She's been active tonight, but I haven't seen the name before.
Good night, JR. Cutification.
Right? Oh my God, Wisdom is better. I said the same thing.
Rakisha Evans said she's new.
That yellow snow. I said, it's not like, when I told him today, I'm like, that's really yellow snow, doggy. You really made yellow snow. Okay. Who's it?
Rakisha
Evans? Okay, yeah, she's active tonight.
No bite.
Okay. Beverly Mayweather said, doggy is adorable.
We're saying
Rakisha's new.
Okay, he doesn't want me.
All right.
He's not bothered with me right now.
Oh, Kim Gregory. Okay, Lux Curls.
My Angel Marcinkovich. I was glad that my dad was in the house. Please pop in next week. And Dad just said goodnight. Night, Padre. All
right.
Night, Eerie. Night, Curly Angel.
I know, guys. I said to him, I said, when he comes back at Christmas time, I said, would you guys like to see me and Jay together? I said, telling you guys, just talking to you guys, just chatting, sharing our lives, so to speak, as if we haven't learned enough from that. I thought we'd bring the Mad Dad on and kind of like introduce him.
Good night, everyone saying good night.
Night, y'all.
It's a Thursday.
Night, ladies. Yeah, I know.
Night.
Oh, good night. This was fun. Good night. Dougie, say good night. You're back to people. Isn't that nice?
He's like, yeah.
Don't forget to like on your way out.
Lots of kisses.
So many kisses.
Give me kisses.
How many kisses?
Dougie. There's nothing on my hand, Dougie. No, there's nothing on my hand. There is nothing. There is nothing.
Well, there'll be a video on Saturday. I'm hoping I'm Saturday because that would mean I have my tree.
What's today? Thursday?
Today is Thursday.
Yeah, like hopefully maybe like a Black Friday haul or live, one or the other. Because we want to get the tree tomorrow and let it fall.
Definitely get the tree.
And then
tree.
We do want to decorate the tree with you guys. He's a mini golden doodle.
Doggy. Can you only come to me? Doggy. I think they say first generation. I think there's a difference. Second generation is if a mini golden doodle and another mini golden doodle have a mini golden doodle. But he's first generation, so his mother was a poodle, I think, and his father was a golden retriever. So he's first generation golden doodle. At times, I think he looks more golden retriever. But he has the curls of a poodle, I think.
Nuggy.
Oh, but he's so good natured. I mean, they really are good natured dogs. And he just has to be trained a little bit better. Because you don't really listen that good, but.
What's that
we'll
about?
Keep you.
What's that about?
We'll keep you a little bit longer. Pretty soon it'll be a lifetime. Yeah, he looks like a poodle. Yeah. Yeah, the look of a poodle. So I know the breeds are so interesting like that. How they have the Labradoodle, like these poodle mixes. Multi-poos, the Maltese and the poodle. He's a golden retriever and a poodle. I just thought, like, I didn't know they existed. Years ago, I had a really cute dog, like, way before him, 25 years ago. I had a Lhasa Apso, and he was so good-natured. But I don't think these dogs existed back then. I mean, the face is so cute. I mean, what a combination, a golden retriever and a poodle. It's just really, 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 really sweet and cute. He just looks like a teddy bear. And we got him strictly for his curls. And as we're sitting here doing this, your father sent me a text that said, 10 things you need to know about golden doodles before you buy them. I wish we would have seen that video.
Right? Okay, why you got the wiggles?
I said, don't get a golden doodle before watching this. Too late.
Dougie.
Yeah, we got him strictly for his curly hair because we thought he'd fit with the channel. And we had right, no Dougie, idea how Dad, active
down.
He was.
Dougie, sit. Dougie, can we sit down, please? Can we sit? Can we sit down? Okay,
good boy. Don't let him bang his head.
Bang your head. Oh, he's done with me. Here he comes.
The breed is super chill. I can't wait for one day. He's not really aggressive, right?
No.
He's just a sweetie pie.
I love it when he takes naps with me. That's the highlight of my life.
Yeah, you get him to do that.
We'll put on, we put on Dorothy. No, he does that with you, the Wizard of Oz. He'll sit and watch the Wizard of Oz with you. But with me, like, I'll click off all the lights and, like, we'll just lay down on the bed and, like, he'll just go to sleep and, like, he'll be on his back, I'll be on my back, he'll be drooling, I'll be drooling, like, best sleeps. Me and Doggy can sleep for, like, 4 or 5 hours, just we'll be knocked out.
We gotta have a nap this weekend. We have to have one of them good naps, Doggy. It's been a while.
Me and Doggy match. She has camouflage on. I have camouflage.
All right. It is past Doggy's bedtime, though.
Okay.
So we have to put Doggy to bed. It's past my bedtime, too, to be honest. Mm-hmm. And we know.
I have puppy fever. You know what, Sarah? That's so tomorrow. Funny. I think a lot of people do. I've seen more people on the timeline getting doggies. And I'm like, I wonder if that's because of Doggy. You see Doggy and then you want a Doggy.
Doggy. All right, guys. This has been so fun.
I know.
So keep a lookout for maybe a live this weekend because we do want to decorate our tree with you guys. And we'll try to give you guys some warning. Mm-hmm. Even though we're busted, YouTubers. So we're going to give you guys some warning for our tree decorating.
Yeah.
But it probably most likely will take place this week, Saturday, Sunday, one of these days.
Yeah, because I won't be a tree.
We'll be decorate our
Let me
tree.
Kiss. Let me kiss. Thank you. Thank you, Doggy. Okay. Plenty of kisses. I didn't do all that much to deserve all that.
Right?
Just holding you.
Good night, guys.
All right.
And have a great night. Great day tomorrow. Great weekend.
Night, see you guys tweeting. Soon.
Why got that hood on? I'm crazy.
Because I told you I'm freezing.
Oh, okay.
It's draft here.
I just looked over and there you are just looking crazy. Yeah. Hold on. Okay.
The draft, I said.
How long's that hood been on?
Probably like the last 10 minutes, guys, right? Freezing
like
cold.
A Ninja Turtle. I can't.
I know.
Okay. All right.
I know.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. All right.
Okay, guys.
Bye, guys. Hope we'll see you Saturday.
Yeah.
Say goodnight, Doggy, say goodnight.
Doggy, say goodnight.
Doggy, say goodnight.
I think that's his goodnight.
All right, that's his goodnight.
All right. Bye, guys.
All right, bye.